Welcome to the Cheez-It Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. And today from Camping World Stadium in sunny Orlando, Florida, the number 18 Miami Hurricanes face the number 21 Oklahoma State Cowboys in the only matchup of ranked opponents outside of the New Year's Six Bowls. Miami comes to Orlando 8-2, Oklahoma State at 7-3. Great to have you with us, everybody. And from the studios here in Bristol, Connecticut, I'm Dave O'Brien. My partner at home in Nashville, Tennessee, is Tim Hasselbeck. Katie George will be on the field there in Orlando. Tim, we've got a good one here today.
We certainly do. Two good football teams, ranked teams, Dave, as you said. And I think they're evenly matched. They're both eager to, you know, be refreshed and have an opportunity to compete in this football game. And not to mention, when you look at both offenses, they average scoring about 30 points per game. So we could be in for some fireworks.
Oklahoma State making their 15th consecutive bowl appearance. We take a look at how the Cowboys arrived in Orlando. They came charging out of the gate at 4-0. That included a pair of nice wins against Tulsa and top 20 Iowa State. The Cowboys would reach number 6 in the poll, and they had a second-half lead against Texas before falling in overtime. And well before the Cheez-It Bowl, top running back Chuba Hubbard opted out, although in truth, Tim, he had barely played in a month or so leading up to that decision, but Tylan Wallace will play.
Yeah, and that's a big opt-in for Oklahoma State. The passing game runs through him. He's a complete player. He'll fight for the football. He's got good run after the catch. He's tough. He was described to us as a throwback. He certainly grabbed our attention preparing for this game, and I know he's grabbed Miami's attention as well.
All right, the Hurricanes of Miami, 8-2. They also got off to a quick start before running up against eventual ACC champion Clemson in October. The Canes were able to shake that one off, however, and win their next five. They climbed to number 10 in the college football rankings. That's when the quarterback, De'Ara King, really got rolling. Miami was 8-1 when they were blown out by number 17, North Carolina, allowing 62 points to the Tar Heels and their tremendous rushing attack. Certainly not the way Miami figured they would end the regular season, but giving up 778 total yards, the most in school history, a huge chunk of those, Tim, on the ground.
Yeah, and that has certainly left a bad taste in Miami's mouth. Manny Diaz described his team as emotionally bankrupt kind of during and after that game. That's why they're so excited to have a better performance defensively, but they're going to have to do it without their two best defensive players who have decided to opt out, Jalen Phillips and Quincy Roche. So it's going to have to be the offense that carries this Hurricane team.
Well, the Canes offense is in great hands. De'Ara King, and Tim, Manny Diaz says, if he's on the bus, we can win the game. Coming out of Houston and then transferring, and he has had a tremendous season after a 1-3 start as a freshman in 2019, coming back and playing some great, great football for Miami.
Yeah, he's been everything they hoped he would be, both on the field and off of it. His production is certainly, you know, jumps out at you. We've seen him a few times, Dave. We think he's one of the more exciting players in all of college football. There's certainly a buzz that he brings to this team tonight and obviously going forward.
And for more on King, let's toss it down to Katie George.
Well, Manny Diaz lights up when he tells you De'Ara King chose Miami twice. Back in January when he committed, it was under the assumption that he would play in one season and then declare for the NFL draft. Then COVID-19 hit and players were granted an extra year of eligibility. He told me he didn't give it much thought until after the North Carolina loss. He sat down with his family to discuss his future. He said he wrote out the pros and cons of declaring for the NFL draft and returning to Miami for a second season. He said his love for his teammates, the culture, the direction Manny Diaz is taking this program, and the opportunity to play in Rhett Lashley's system in consecutive seasons were among the pros that helped him make this decision. He said he trusted his gut and he's ready to run it back in 2021, guys.
Well, it was great news, certainly, Coral Gables, Florida. He is the Canes' most highly respected player on both sides of the football. Manny Diaz will tell you that. Last year, 6-7, a major turnaround at 8-2. And Mike Gundy used to be a big star quarterback for Oklahoma State on his 16th season. As mentioned, 15 consecutive bowl appearances for the Cowboys. Beautiful evening here in Orlando, 75 degrees, partly sunny skies as we get set to get this one underway. Miami won the toss and they have deferred to the second half. kicking game, a big reason that Miami was able to turn things around. Borregales there about to kick off. He's an All-American, first team All-American named this week. Hurricanes two losses coming to Clemson and North Carolina. They have only faced Oklahoma State once before. That was in 1991, one of the seasons they won a national championship, one of the five for the Hurricanes. And we are underway on a pretty night here in Orlando. And about to get it going between two teams ranking in the top 25. The quarterback, Spencer Sanders, about to come out for the Cowboys, an honorable mention, all Big 12. Tim, he's a good athlete, a good runner.
He is a very good runner. He's a highly recruited player coming out of high school, decides to go to Oklahoma State, and has had a lot of success, especially early on. He's an excellent carrier of the football. He's pretty good in the passing game. He certainly has the arm strength to attack all areas of the field. And he's really developing into a nice player for Oklahoma State.
Had a 400-yard passing game, four touchdowns in that overtime loss to Texas. Going to throw it immediately here, and a completion to pick up the first down. And it is on target to Wallace, taken down by DJ Ivy. Look for that combination a lot. Wallace, an All-American as a sophomore, truly one of the finest wide receivers in college football today.
He's a lot of fun to watch preparing for this football game, and I would be surprised if Miami gives him many free access throws like they did there on first down.
Sanders gonna roll and fire, and nearly picked off, almost intercepted by Couch. Zachary Couch had an opportunity, that right corner off his fingertips.
And Zachary Couch, probably the best corner that Miami has. And you know, Sanders, who does a good job throwing on the run, is just inaccurate here. Misses high and inside as he's trying to get the ball to Landon Wolf, and he's fortunate that wasn't picked.
So brings up second down and 10 for the Cowboys. Miami defense, as Tim mentioned, trying to overcome the loss of a couple of guys who are going to be playing on Sundays very, very soon. And a low pass going to be caught by Wolf, Landon Wolf. And Wolf is a senior out of Tulsa, Oklahoma, made 21 catches this season, third down and 5. Sanders looking to move the chains, darts that one for a first down. Into heavy traffic, but the completion to Wolf again to move the sticks.
Yeah, one of the things Oklahoma State does a nice job of, you see how quickly they get to the line of scrimmage, but it's different formations. In that third down, to get into a bunch set, and Wolf was just able to sit in the zone, easy completion for the first down.
Both of these offenses want to go very, very fast, certainly giving the Cowboys an advantage with the pass rushers, Phillips and Roche, opting out for the NFL. First down and 10. And Sanders with some play action. Plenty of time in the pocket. And fires that one complete. So out of the gate, finding Wallace again a couple of times. Couch with the tackle. And Wallace really a true game breaker. All Big 12 first team. Hasn't played since December 5th because of a knee injury, but he's looking sharp here early. Second down, one. Going to throw it again. And a slant here to Wallace, the target, and they'll move him again.
I mean, it's remarkable, David. We talked to Blake Baker, defensive coordinator for Miami, and he said, look, we're going to roll coverage to him. We're going to give him all kinds of attention. They've actually done that after the first down, first play of the game. And he's still involved in the passing game.
Is Brown, the running back, to scamper out of bounds after the completion, chased out by Couch. And the Cowboys have had some offensive highlights. At 47 points against Kansas, 50 against Texas Tech, 42 against Baylor, but some injuries, particularly up front, Tim, have slowed them down, so they've been somewhat up and down offensively.
Yeah, and I think we've seen that a lot across the country as teams dealing with the virus, dealing with injuries. Oklahoma State no different in that regard.
Stoner, the man in motion, the intended target, made a tough catch there. Dylan Stoner, the number two wide receiver, caught 37 passes during the regular season. Had a spectacular day against Baylor with Wallace out, 247 receiving yards. So Oklahoma State, 8 plays, all of them passing plays so far.
My kind of game, Dave.
It sure is. But I think a big surprise to many who had previewed this game, expecting the Cowboys to come out and run it against Miami. Going to throw it again, but incomplete. And good coverage again by Couch, who's been all over the place.
Couch is basically in zone coverage here. He's just going to look inside and trap the outbreaking route. And they can't connect there with Brandon Presley. I think the reason that you see Oklahoma State coming out throwing the football is they like their wide receivers against these secondary players for Miami, feel like they match up well speed-wise and ability to go fight for the football.
Well, fourth down and 6, going to go for it here. Very confident in that passing game right away. Sanders, good time. Going to roll and throw it deep. And a tremendous catch, lunging for the end zone, and a touchdown. Oklahoma State getting it to Presley for 6. Brandon Presley hauls it in. What a catch at the goal line. And then lunging to make sure he got in for the Cowboys.
What a catch is right, Dave. You see, it just comes back to the football. You know, as Sanders escaped outside the pocket, Presley kind of gets away from the coverage. Ball is a little bit underthrown, but it's an excellent job of Presley fighting back through contact to go make the catch.
Well, spectacular effort there. And Oklahoma State strikes first here in the Cheez-It Bowl, 7-0.
And it's Sanders just doing an excellent job escaping outside the pocket, moving to his left. And then the freshman going up and making a big time play.
Back at the 2020 Cheez-It Bowl at Camping World Stadium in Orlando, Florida. Tim Hasselbeck, I think Mike Gundy just put Miami in a state of shock coming out, slinging the football like that with that passing attack.
Well, calling a football game like a former quarterback, 10 straight passes, just incredible, and a great job by Spencer Sanders, and a great job by Brandon Presley, the true freshman wide receiver, making a play on fourth down.
A great catch, great effort to get into the end zone. And so now Miami with Mike Harley will bring out the kickoff. And Harley, one of the top wide receivers, certainly for De'Eric King, senior out of Marble, Texas, honorable mention, all ACC. Also rushed for over 500 yards. He passed for almost 2,600. Timmy accounted for 26 touchdowns with his arm and legs.
Yeah, he was awesome this season, and they really use him as a design runner. Even though he's not that big of a guy, he'll run between the tackles. They'll get him outside as well. He's good when the play breaks down as a runner. He's also a really good passer, very accurate, and a good deep ball thrower.
And he's going to run it on the first possession for the Hurricanes. King on the carry, stopped by Tyler Lacy. Oklahoma State has won 4 of its last 6 bowl games. Miami has dropped 9 of their last 10. So Manny Diaz says we got to find a way to win these bowl games, and Harris is tied up and he's taken down. Cameron Harris with the carry. Arvell Peel with the tackle to wrap him up.
Yeah, and listen, Miami's got a tough challenge with this Oklahoma State defense. It's a very good group on that side of the ball. You've seen already on first and second down here out of the fight that they will be in with this front of Oklahoma State.
Lost a yard there, 3rd down and 9. He's going to wing it here for Harris. He gets free of a tackler, gets across the 30. Talk about a fine second effort before how the field brought him down, but Cameron Harris picks up the first.
Cameron Harris is a good back. He's physical. He's got good speed. He's kind of the veteran of the group with 2 young guys behind him. That's an outstanding play on 3rd down.
And now the heave by King, and he's going to overshoot his wide receiver. That was intended for Mark Pope, but you see how quickly they want to go. And the OSU defensive coordinator, Jim Knowles, said it's not the speed that's the problem. It's when they freeze. He said, that's when you feel like the guy making a speech in front of a lot of people with no pants on.
Because he doesn't want Rhett Lashley to get a look at what he's, you know, doing defensively. And so because of that, you've got to match their speed, but also not let them read your mail.
Harris trying to bounce outside. Again, shucks a tackler and dives ahead. Tough carry there. McAllister with the stop for the Cowboys. 5'10", 210, and he can be a bruising runner, can't he?
He really can be, and I think that, you know, it's kind of been a unique season for him as some of the young guys have gotten involved in the run game for Miami. There's probably been some frustration, but he's really been the reliable back, you know, the guy that's good in pass protection, good on third downs, and he's a physical runner.
Trey Sterling, not fooled by King there, took him down to bring up fourth down and three. And bring on Lou Headley, the outstanding punter. Miami ranks number one in FBS in net punting. That might be the least interesting thing about Lou Headley, the Australian rules football player who picked that number 94 at Miami because his idol Dwayne The Rock Johnson wore it as a Hurricane. And then you get to the fact, Tim, he's 6'4", 230, so he probably ought to be a linebacker. He's a punter.
He does look like a linebacker. That was his rugby days.
And virtually blanketed in tattoos all over his body. 7-0, Oklahoma State.
The Cheez-It Bowl, brought to you by Cheez-It. Cheesy, crunchy bowl season satisfaction. And Duke's Mayonnaise, the only mayo with that southern something, that added oomph. Duke's, it's got twang.
Here in Orlando, you see the Cheez-It wheels in the stands. Tim, this is supposed to be us. I think they nailed you here.
That's pretty good. In fact, it's really good.
Yeah, my nickname at Syracuse, Cheez-It wheel. First down and 10 here for the Cowboys. Sanders gonna run it this time and stays on his feet as he scampers out. Spencer Sanders, injuries have been a factor in his season to an extent, and not really being on a par with his first year in Stillwater when he was named Big 12 Offensive Freshman of the Year. But in that first drive, he showed you a little bit of what he's capable of. He wants to throw from the pocket again and complete once again, this time to Dylan Stoner. Taken down by to Corey Couch again, but Stoner's a huge target as well. We mentioned a great day he had against Baylor. Very sure-handed, deceptively fast. He spent most of his career as the second option behind some great wide receivers at Oklahoma State.
But he's had 3 years with 40 or more catches, just to kind of give you a sense of his production, and just really reliable, always where the quarterback is expecting him to be.
Just fires again and complete again. Once again, it's Wolf who breaks free to pick up the first down and into Miami territory.
And part of what's happening is Tylan Wallace is drawing, you know, some attention. You have a corner rolled up on him, a safety up high. Oklahoma State's running some of these RPOs, these run pass options, and, you know, the overhang defender is committing to stop the run, which is leading Spencer Sanders to just spit the ball outside into the flat.
Now the Miami defensive coaches told us this week, we're going to try to have two men around him at all times, talking about Wallace. Sanders, and that one deflected as it pops up, and Wallace somehow converged on it and made the play. And so winds up going for five.
Well, sometimes it's good to be lucky and good, which is what happened here. Tips and overthrows are awful for a quarterback. He has a sail route open to his left. He's trying to throw it there as the ball's batted. It's just Wallace who's aware and comes back to the football. Nice job.
And you know things are going well for the Cowboys in the passing game when that happens. Sanders 11 out of 13 already for over 100 yards and a touchdown to Presley. Just his second catch, by the way, this season. They've made a tremendous play to get into the end zone. Sanders wants to throw short. It's Wallace again. He's going to spin around and fight for that marker. Spun around by Williams. Cam Williams, one of the guys filling in for Quincy Roche. of the opt-outs for Miami.
That's just outstanding run after the catch on a wide receiver screen that's not blocked that well. Kylan Wallace, just ability to make people miss, fall forward, pick up the first down.
So first and 10 coming up for the Cowboys. Spencer Sanders off to a hot start for Oklahoma State here in the Cheez-It Bowl. Going to bring pressure. A handoff for Jackson. Jackson bouncing outside across the 30. And he's dragged down inside the 10-yard line by Sam Brooks.
And this is controlling the tempo offensively. They just run away from the blitz. They're bringing Gilbert Frierson off of, you know, the offense's right. And they just decide to run it away from it. Nice pickup.
First and goal for the Cowboys. Brown stacked up in the center of the line. So not much there. They'll bring up second down and goal. And Oklahoma State already in front here, 7-0, and looking for more against Miami. On this drive, 7 plays, 72 yards. Sanders looking for the end zone, but overshot. Flag down. That was intended for Landon Wolf. All the strong safety with the contact, and that brings the penalty.
It's going to run a little switch route here as you see Wallace up top and kind of almost like this bubble and then get vertical. You're trying to get some traffic.
Pass interference. Defense, number 26. The ball will be placed in the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Just too much contact by Gervin Hall. Really wasn't in bad position. If you just stayed over the top and looked for the football, it might have been okay.
So first and goal for Oklahoma State. Sanders looking to power the Cowboys into the end zone again. Brown with a handoff, going strong, and he's going to power his way into the end zone. Oklahoma State strikes again. L.D. Brown, the senior from Dallas who had missed the previous 3 games, not missing this one.
For an offensive line that's banged up, they sure get a lot of movement. They just run power. You know, down, and around. The right side of the offensive line is blocking down. They pull the guard around, and that's just good power football. Blocking your man into the end zone. That's the coaching point. Go score with your man. Logan Carter does that.
You got a man
pretty
down
good
here.
Effort by the guys up front.
Man down for Miami, Tim. That is Jonathan Ford. The tackle, 6'5 by 320, the senior from Fort Lauderdale, injured on that play on which the Cowboys scored again and on the verge of going up 14-0. And now you see the ground attack coming into play for Oklahoma State. Brown, along with Jackson and Richardson, have done a great job taking over with Hubbard out. He really didn't get the feel, even though Chuba Hubbard had a fine career, was second team all Big 12. You didn't get the feeling, talking to Coach Gundy and everybody else for the Cowboys this week, that they considered that a gigantic loss because he's been missing for so long.
It certainly didn't feel that way talking to them. Is, you know, they feel like they've got three really capable backs, and getting L.D. Brown back in the lineup, he did miss the last three, and they have a kind of a stable of backs. And you think about Desmond Jackson, doesn't have a single negative run this season. It's pretty good for a guy that has over 500 yards rushing. And yeah, I think they feel like they can roll them in, keep them fresh, and because of that, you know, maybe it doesn't feel like there's much of a drop off in their run game.
Jonathan Ford has to be helped off. And Oklahoma State looking for the extra point. Brady Pohl. And he drills that to make it 14-0 Cowboys.
The offense for Oklahoma State, 14-0 Cowboys.
Well, the last two bowl games coming up on Saturday, 4 Eastern, number 25, Oregon taking on number 10, Iowa State. The PlayStation Fiesta Bowl, then it's number 5, Texas A&M, and number 13, North Carolina, in the Capital One Orange Bowl at Hard Rock Stadium, of course, the home of these Miami Hurricanes. They're trying to get their offense going behind King and company. North Carolina, a team that you and I covered quite a bit this season. A lot of offensive weapons have opted out. And most of the guys kind of leaving Sam Howell all by himself, too.
Yeah, a little bit, probably a bad feeling for Sam Howell. And, you know, I think you're probably getting a pretty angry, motivated A&M squad as well. And so Mac Brown, who's done a great job at North Carolina in a short period of time, certainly going to have his hands full.
Mike Harley in motion. And we'll see if there's a counter here from Miami. Short pass. Going to pick up a first down on that play as he got it to Brevin Jordan, the tight end. The better tight ends in a tight end rich conference in the ACC.
It sure is. And Brevin Jordan's among the best of them. And, you know, he's a guy that I think they really need to get involved against this defense. You know, you look back at the Kansas State game for Oklahoma State, and I had some issues with the tight end, and it wasn't a guy of Brevin Jordan's caliber.
Harley trying to make something on that sideline. Top receiver, the fastest man from Miami, taken down by Malcolm Rodriguez, who after a 4-yard pickup took him out of play. Rodriguez leading the Big 12 in solo tackles with 52. He was, after all, an All-State wrestler in high school in Oklahoma. It was Harley again, trying to bounce out, trying to get free. He's going to be stopped by Trey Sterling.
You know, in this defense, as you get third down here for Miami, this defense for Oklahoma State has been tremendous on third down. One of the best in the country. And they just find a way, kind of switch looks up, you know, rally to the football. You know, you mentioned Rodriguez, the former safety, the high school quarterback. He's got good speed, good instincts. And, you know, I think this kind of three safety defense does a good job in these third and mediums.
Well, they sure do. They're number two nationally in stopping the opponent on third down. King's going to be well shy of a first down as Murray made the tackle. That's a very good defense. This defense has scored 4 touchdowns this season. That's number one in FBS, 3 fumbles and a pick six, so they get it done.
You almost get the sense for Miami a little bit with how it's going, already down 14. You know, that maybe want to pick up that first down right here on fourth down.
Fourth and 2, so they'll go for it. Down by 2 touchdowns. This is, of course, one of those situations where they're not going at warp speed. They send Pope right behind the quarterback. King to roll. He's going to throw it up there, and it's broken up. And he's stopped on a play by Christian Holmes, intended for the tight end, Jordan.
Well, I think it's the right idea by Miami. Move your quarterback, who's mobile, throws well on the run. Try to get it to your big tight end, and the ball's just a little bit underthrown. And Brevin Jordan probably needs to fight back through contact a little bit better, because Christian Holmes is kind of right there, and even though he doesn't look back for the football, doesn't make enough contact with Jordan for there to be a pass interference call.
Oh, King, you know, thought King otherwise,
sees,
yeah.
Yeah, well, he sees it differently, and I understand that. It is close, but to me, and look, I generally favor the offense. Not enough contact there for a flag. Big stop by that Oklahoma State defense.
Right off the back of the helmet of Holmes. So first and 10, I'll tell you, Manny Diaz was livid that there was no interference penalty. Take a look at this.
Yeah, I mean, I think that classifies as livid when you're throwing your call sheet and your headset down. I just think Brevin Jordan needs to kind of put his foot in the ground and make it an easy call for the official rather than fading away to the football. Ball's in the air. Who cares what your route was? You don't have to continue to the corner. Fight back to the football through contact, and you'll get the call.
Second down, 10. Completed pass to Stoner, who took a hit. We talked about the guys that he's been playing behind in his career and waiting his turn to have, you know, big games like he had against Baylor. So third down and one. And Richardson now one of the two running backs. Sanders going to throw. Wallace picks up a first down.
Miami's not lined up right. Third and one, they're thinking about stopping the run. They forget to cover Tylan Wallace, and it's a great job of Spencer Sanders of seeing it, just raising up and throwing the football out there to pick up the first down. Nice job of playing quarterback, being aware.
Look at this for the Cowboys, already 163 yards of offense. Moving the football, Richardson with the carry. True freshman who exploded in the season finale at Baylor for 169 yards and three touchdowns. That was second at OSU for a freshman, only to the great Thurman Thomas, who went for 206 yards in 1984 against K-State. Second and nine. Richardson remaining in. He'll carry it again to the center of the line. And he will gain on that play 2 yards to bring up third down.
It just feels like after what happened to Miami against North Carolina, you're down 14-0 in the first quarter. You got to find a way to get a stop. You finally get to a third and seven, and that should favor the defense. Find a way to get off the field if you're Miami.
Sanders to put it in the air again, and another completed pass to Presley. He's in the open field, heading for the end zone. He is in for another touchdown. And the freshman has already had himself a night, 32 yards, and the Cowboys get six more.
Had himself a night is right. One catch on the season. He's got two tonight, and they're both for touchdowns. Does a good job sitting at the zone here. Ball's right on him. Excellent throw, good timing. And then how about the speed in space? I guess you have to be if you're 5'8", 165. But good job of getting the football in your hands, securing it, and then getting up the field.
Presley already with two touchdown catches, and both of them really have been spectacular. 21-0 Oklahoma State here in the Cheez-It Bowl.
Yeah, spectacular is right. He's in the slot here, inside, and Stoner outside on the bottom of your screen. And he's just going to sit in the hole of this zone coverage, basically cover two to his side, sits down between the corner and the linebacker. And then once the ball was in his hands, how about the giddy up? Just awareness in the open field. It's hard to believe that he had one catch on the season. He's got two tonight, both for scores.
Well, it really looks like Miami wasn't prepared for any of this. They weren't ready for Presley. Certainly, you have every reason to think that Tylan Wallace is the guy you better cover with more than one guy. Second career touchdown for Presley, both of them in this game. As Tim mentioned, he had had one catch this season. But he's having a tremendous bowl game. So Miami in deep trouble right away. Here's Harley trying to bring it out. He's following a blocker. He's getting across the 40-yard line, and a big carry back on the return, although a flag is down. And Miami needed a jolt. Let's see what the penalty is here. 21-0 Cowboys. And inside the last minute of play here in the first quarter.
During the return, blocking the back receiving team, number seven. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
So it was a 41-yard return, but the penalty.
And they're calling it on Xavier Restrepo, and oh man. And I guess, I mean, to me, that's a rough one. It's basically the kicker turning his back, trying to rally to the football, and Restrepo actually tries to avoid him. And I guess you can understand what the official sees, but I don't like that call.
Jordan, tight end, trying for that marker and got it. Eventually stopped by Trey Sterling, but Brevin Jordan, as mentioned, second team all ACC in a conference loaded with tight ends, led by BC's Hunter Long and Duke's Noah Gray, Tony Poljan of Virginia, among a long list. Gonna fire it back to the quarterback, King. And King on a trick play is loose across the 40-yard line. So the double pass and 15 yards for that game.
Well, it is bowl season, Dave, so that does mean you got to get some trick plays. Miami gets into an unbalanced, spit it out like it's a little bubble or perimeter throw, and you know, would not be surprised if they have something more down the field off of that same look.
First down 10. D. Wiggins in motion. King time in the pocket. He's going to fire that one, and a completed pass. He got it to Cheney for the first down to end the first quarter. So Miami, some much-needed momentum, because that first quarter was all Cowboys down.
That is the end of the first quarter.
Welcome back to the Cheez-It Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. Central Florida, Orlando all dressed up for the holidays. Oklahoma State, the Cowboys off to a tremendous start, a 21-0 lead on the Miami Hurricanes. Dave O'Brien along with Tim Hasselbeck, Katie George there in Orlando. And this one feels very big for Miami, the scamper by King. I realize it's just the early seconds of the second quarter, Tim, but it feels huge for Miami.
It certainly does. I mean, down 21, your last time out, kind of had an offensive explosion run you off the field a little bit. And kind of was starting to have that North Carolina game feeling, which was the feeling that Manny Diaz felt like his football team had to get out of, you know, the taste out of their mouth. And so, yeah, down in tight here, a response feels like, you know, maybe give this team a little bit more life.
King rushing for three. Brings up second down and seven for the Canes. Eric thinks so much of their offense running right through him. He'll go to the end zone for the touchdown. Caught by Brevin Jordan, the tight end. Yeah, must have from Miami. A 10-yard strike, and the Canes are on the board.
Well, there's the answer. That's a great response. And it is Brevin Jordan. We've talked about, you said, Dave, you know, obviously a really good tight end. He's in the slot here. He's just going to run to the post. A little seam that'll bend to the middle coming off of the play action. It's good timing by Derek King. Good ball location for his big tight end.
So the All-American Borregales on for the extra point. An absolute must there for Miami if they're going to say they're back in the football game. As we get the second quarter underway, that'll make it 21-7.
Well, Miami fights back. Derek King with a couple plays finds his star tight end over the middle for seven.
The Cheez-It Bowl, brought to you by Cheez-It. Cheesy, crunchy bowl season satisfaction.
Number 18, Miami, on the scoreboard against number 21, Oklahoma State. Dave O'Brien, Tim Hasselbeck, Katie George. And a game tonight from Orlando as Miami gets into the end zone on the strike by De'Ara King to his tight end, Brevin Jordan. And Miami sticking their toe back into the football game. Borregales to launch the kick. It'll come out to the 25 to begin the drive. Well, there's the great Ed Reed, who is Miami's chief of staff, on a championship team in 01. College Football Hall of Famer, NFL Hall of Famer. For more on Ed, let's toss it down to Katie.
Well, guys, Miami defenders were certainly relieved as they watched Brevin Jordan find the end zone. But Ed Reed has been busy down here on the sidelines. Multiple DBs have had conversations with him during the break. Manny Diaz brought Reed on staff during the offseason. He says he's been instrumental as another set of eyes for Diaz and in helping this Miami secondary. Pretty cool to be able to learn from somebody like Ed Reed.
Yeah, one of the best. Oklahoma State with the football on the carry. It's L.D. Brown and still powering ahead. I think not many coaches can say they had as many moves pay off in one season, Tim, as Manny Diaz in 2020 after going 6-7 the year before. Ed Reed was a huge one. He also brought in a new offensive coordinator in Rhett Lashley from SMU. He remade the coaching staff, did a lot of great things. Ed Reed's career, this is his first year as the Miami chief of staff. You betcha they're gonna listen when Ed talks.
I think it's safe to say that's the most swag a chief of staff has ever had, ever. I mean, and you're right, though, in all seriousness about the hires, certainly Ed Reed, and you know, he's a great player, but I think he's just got a great sense of the locker room. That's what Manny loves about Ed Reed, and clearly the influence of Rhett Lashley and how they've done in the transfer situation with Derek King. Manny Diaz did a lot of things right with hires and who he brought into this program.
Ed, by the way, 64 interceptions in his NFL career on his way to the Hall of Fame. Sanders to roll and fire short, and another completion. It's Stoner again. We talked about the guys that he's played behind in his career, along, you know, Pittsburgh Steeler James Washington, who won the Biletnikoff Award, and Tylan Wallace, a finalist for the Biletnikoff Award. Now, when are you going to get your chance?
And I think that he's been patient. He's been unselfish. He's been a versatile player, so that when other guys have been the one, he can be the complimentary guy that, you know, plays inside, can't play outside, all of that. And he's had a really nice career, and I think, you know, he's enjoying some of the success this season.
Brown on the carry, finds some room to romp, gets across the 50, picking up a first down for the Cowboys. We talked about Stoner having a couple of great days in his career, but I mean, they just seem to churn out the sensational wide receivers for the Cowboys.
They really have a history of wide receivers at this school and quarterbacks, and here you go.
Another trick play, and this one winds up in the hands of Sanders to the 50-yard line, and out he goes. As you said, bowl season, it's the time for trickery and deceit.
It is. You want guys to have fun. They're looking over the sideline. What play are we going to run? Nope. Direct snap to the running back. Ball touches three players' hands, and it's actually a really good decision by Spencer Sanders, because it wasn't there. Miami was in position just to pick up a few yards and get out of bounds.
Second and 7. Gonna look to throw again. He wins that one. It's Presley, who's been his favorite target tonight. He goes tumbling ahead for another first. Couch with the stop, but an 18-yard gain.
That's kind of remarkable. Oklahoma State.
Another catch. He gets by another tackler before they shove him. Did he step out? Couch able to shove him. And picking up another first.
Well, I mean, you just look at his quickness. Are you kidding me? That is, I mean, that's a crossover you can't believe right there. Foot in the ground, and Brian Balam, who's pursuing to the sideline, you know, barely gets a hand on him. You get a sense of his quickness with the
party. Well, picked up 14 there, and he almost stayed on his feet all the way to the end zone. Carry by Richardson right into the pile. Staying on the ground there for a 2-yard gain. Cowboys leading at 21-7 and hungry for more here in the second quarter.
I feel like the tempo that Oklahoma State is operating with offensively is really taking its toll on Miami. Hard time getting lined up, and then you don't know when they're slowing you down to get a look at you.
Sanders trying to find that end zone again. Second and 8. They'll throw it again, and another completed pass on the near sideline to Tay Martin. shoved out by Couch, who's been called on to do a lot of heavy lifting here early. That'll pick up three. Couch, the sophomore out of Fort Lauderdale. How about this arm slot for Spencer Sanders?
He certainly found a way to find a bunch of completions. He's definitely adjusted his arm angle at times. I've been impressed with his just awareness in the pocket, some subtle movement to just create a little bit more time to be able to push the ball down the field.
Stay on the ground, but not much there for Dominic Richardson. Not on that carry. They lose two, in fact, the stop by Cam Williams, the freshman.
But Dave, to pick up on the arm slot thing, when you run these RPOs, you know, you're not blocking the pass. And so you have to find a throwing lane. There's certainly an art to it, and Spencer Sanders has done a good job with it.
Brady Pohl coming on. He'll attempt this from 28 yards. And a flag down. 8:58 to go in the second.
False start. Offense, number 96, five-yard penalty, fourth down.
So that will back up Brady Pohl here, who was thrust into action when the number one kicker, Alex Hale, got hurt. Hale, by the way, another Australian. It's all Big 12 honorable mention. So this is from 33. For the freshman from Kansas City, Kansas. Going to fire that one up, and that is going to be no good. So he missed it, and Manny Diaz, a happy man at the moment despite the score. Oklahoma State is denied. They cannot add to their total. See if that swings some momentum for Miami. Now let's take a look at our clutch delivery brought to you by Chipotle.
The clutch delivery is coming from Spencer Sanders. He's been outstanding from inside the pocket, showing a bunch of poise, doing a good job with that. There's that adjusted arm angle and arm slot. Then the ability to escape and create offense, moving to his left, able to find Presley for the first score. I've been really impressed with him. I mean, there's a calmness in the pocket and really accurate, and yeah, you should at a high step and be excited for how the night has gone so far. Spencer Sanders,
19 for 22, 205 yards, two touchdowns. Miami to run it, and looking to bounce outside. Chaney down the sideline, trying to cut back in. A huge gain for the Canes. That rush for 44 yards.
Yeah, coming off the missed field goal. How about this momentum swing? It's Chaney. He's got good speed, true freshman. They're really excited about him. He's been more involved as the season has gone along, and you see it there, the vision and the speed, and fortunately, it seems like they're walking this one back.
See where he stepped out, that's the key. So back that up to a 27-yard rush because he stepped out of bounds. King wanting to go fast and incomplete, underthrown. And intended for D. Wiggins. So brings up second down for the Hurricanes, trying to capitalize after the missed field goal. Down 21-7. Here in the Cheez-It Bowl in Orlando. De'Aaron King had some game against NC State. 430 yards, five touchdown passes. And they're going to stop him. Nothing doing there as Brock Martin saw that one coming and tied up King.
And when you look at what you want to do against quarterback runs, you have to be active and twist. You see that little stunt there to bring Brock Martin inside. You know, to a quarterback, it looks like a running lane. But here comes a defensive lineman wrapping around. That's a nice play call by Jim Knowles, the defensive coordinator, to have that stunt in there and basically entice Derek King to run, and then Brock Martin there for the tackle.
Third and long here for the Canes. And third and 12, he's back to throw. Going to throw it long. It's going to be incomplete. There's a flag down. He wanted Mike Harley, his number one target, who caught 49 passes this season. But a flag on the play. And Harley already celebrating.
Pass interference. Defense number 31. The ball we placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
It's Harvell Peel who basically just, you know, kind of overplays it and gets flat-footed, and Hartley's running full speed, reaches out and grabs him. Clearly a penalty and a pretty big break for Miami on third and long.
Harvell Peel, one of the top men in the secondary with a couple of interceptions, but was third and 12. Now on first and 10, Harris going to try and cut back inside, so penalty could be very, very big indeed. Trey Sterling with the stop. Defense has been such a big factor for the Cowboys all season long. And looking for another stop here. Second down and 9. Miami now with 139 total yards. Of course, most of the Cowboys have come in the air. On second down, he's going to try and run it. Then it's going to extend him out. Chased out by Christian Holmes. And King with very little room to operate there. He's going to gain 5.
And I think here, when you look at what Miami likes to do in these situations, it's probably get a look at the defense. Don't be surprised to see a double count so that Rhett Lashley can get a sense of what Oklahoma State is doing defensively to get to the call he wants.
Third down and 3. Harley on the move. King to throw. Finds Harley. He gets the first down, and he's going to get something extra as well. He kept on moving before Harvell Peel finally got him.
Nice job here. You run Harley, basically a little bit of a stacked release, and that traffic there is what gets Harley so wide open. Just running to the flat. Good timing by Derek King.
It's super tempo again as Harley pulls ahead and just shy of the first down marker, he steps out. And Miami getting fired up here. There's a flag down. 5:34 to go before halftime. Ed Lashley, there's a lot of talk about the offensive coordinator for Miami maybe moving on as a head coach.
Illegal substitution. Defense. 12 players on the field. That penalty is declined. Second down.
Now, Ed Lashley's name came up the opening at Vandy for a couple of weeks there. His name was in the mix. Second down and short here for the Canes. Gang throwing, hitting his tight end. That's Will Mallory. They really have a two-headed monster at tight end between Jordan and Mallory, don't they?
They really do. Will Mallory, a very good player, be a starter, you know, most places. And they kind of feel like when their best 11 are on the field offensively, both of their tight ends, Mallory and Jordan, you know, are on the field. They do rotate them through. Both guys have kind of dealt with injuries this season. They're fortunate to have that kind of depth there.
Good drive here, and it continues first and goal for the Hurricanes. King to keep it, looking for the end zone. Touchdown, Miami. There is a flag on the play. A flag down, but King finds the end zone. And Miami showing a lot of life here. If it holds up, it's a 7-yard touchdown run for De'Ara King. Now we check the penalty.
Holding, offense number 53. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Still first down.
So erase the touchdown on the hold.
Well, the call's on Ja'Kai Clark, number 53, the left guard right there. And it's kind of a zone read with an escort run. It's going up to the linebacker level. And he just reaches out and grabs Rodriguez. And I'm not sure he even needed to do it, Dave. You know, Rodriguez is a good player, but with Derek King's speed, and it just takes a bad angle, and probably would have been better off just letting him go.
So the Canes set up again. And from the 15-yard line. Down 21-7 here in the Cheez-It Bowl. And a timeout.
Timeout, Miami. The first of the half.
Three days to the college football playoff semifinals, New Year's Day on ESPN.
Well, can't make it to the playoff in Miami? Join us virtually for the college football playoff all-access experience featuring exclusive content and a chance to win prizes. You can register today at collegefootballplayoff.com/all-access. Great, great time of year. College football semifinal coming up on Friday. First down and goal here for Miami. Once again in need of a score. This is the 10th play of the drive for King and the Canes. Here's Harley. And spun out of bounds by Trey Sterling, who's been very active out of that secondary for the Cowboys.
Yeah, and that's another one of those plays. We saw that double pass earlier, basically the same formation. They're in unbalanced. You know, they run Harley in motion to the unbalanced side, throw the ball laterally so he would have the option to throw it. And wouldn't be surprised if Miami was just setting something up there on first down.
King, the scamper on the move, a flag drops. And he is upended around the 10-yard line. Again, it's Sterling, and he is down. De'Eric King kind of clutching at that knee as he took a shot. This is something they have not had to worry about this season for the transfer from Houston. He's really been an iron man, but he is down with 4:06 to go in the half. De'Eric King upended, went airborne, and there's the reaction from the Miami sideline as the trainers attend to him.
Defense, zero. Half the distance to the goal from the end of the run. Replay, second down.
A hold on Christian Holmes, but you wonder if even before he took the hit, Tim, when he went to plant, if that's where he might have injured himself. We're going to step away here with 4:06 to go in the first half, and Oklahoma State on top of Miami 21-7. Well, with Miami fans chanting his name, De'Eric King, star quarterback for the Canes, goes right to the tent. Take a look at this play where he was hurt, Tim.
Yeah, and you don't know if it's on that cut right there with his right leg or when there's contact with the knee from Trey Sterling. Either way, you just hate to see it. Does have a history of a knee injury, tore his meniscus in 2018, and you know, now it's going to be Nikosi Perry in at quarterback for the Hurricanes.
The junior from Ocala, Florida, played very little this season. He's going to throw immediately. It's batted down by Trey Sterling as he looked for the end zone. And Perry, who attempted only 13 passes all season, 7 out of 13, one touchdown and one interception, 6'4", 190.
He is 6-3 as a starter, you know, over a three-year, you know, career. And he had Brevin Jordan there. That one has got to hurt a little bit. He's got Brevin Jordan. The ball just gets batted at the line of scrimmage. Otherwise, we've been one for a score.
Third down and goal. Looking for the short pass again, and that one's going to be broken up and incomplete. Rodriguez broke it up, intended for the running back, Harris, and now he's down. Cam Harris is on his back. And De'Eric King out of the tent, needing a lot of help just to walk slowly along the sideline. T. terribly disheartening after the great news this week when he announced in Coral Gables he would return for another year to take advantage of the NCAA eligibility rule and come back in 2021. Let's go down to Katie George.
Dave, Tim, the athletic staff here at Miami, they asked Derek if he wanted them to bring out the cart for him, and he said, no, I'm going to walk it myself. And as you can see, he's barely putting any weight on that right leg. His right knee clearly injured at this moment. But talk about toughness. He said, I'm going to walk the whole way.
Number 52 for Miami is now wearing 82.
I mean, this is one of the reasons they talk about how much they admire him on both sides of the football. The defensive side loves him just as much as the offensive guys do.
Well, and you saw, you know, Bubba Bolden was one of the first guys, the good safety for Miami, was one of the first guys over to check on Derek King. You know, he was down on the ground on the field of play. And there are some guys that will say, listen, no matter what, you know, I'm not coming off the field on a cart. And obviously, Derek King has that mentality. You know, he was described to us as a guy that just loves college football so much. Rhett Lashley even said he's almost like Tim Tebow, the way he just loves college football so much. That's hard to see, just as a fan of college football, to see Derek King exit a game that way.
Now there's Cam Harris, who is injured on the last play, who at times has been the number one running back for Miami this season. Well, Borgalis on from 22 yards to try and get the Canes back on the scoreboard, and he does as he drills the field goal. He is 19 for 21. But the major story here in the final minutes of the first half, certainly the injury to the star quarterback for Miami, De'Ara King, on this play.
Yeah, it's a drive that you come away with points, and it feels like a loss right here because, you know, the player that has given your team so much hope, as you said, Dave, on both sides of the football, leaves the game. You just see the concern from everybody on that Miami sideline, and that's tough. It's hard to overcome, you know, with losing your quarterback in any situation, but, you know, a quarterback that has meant so much to this team and this program in such a short period of time.
Yeah, and Tim, a season that became a triumph for him could have easily gone the other way, you know, transferring to a brand new program, new system. He lost his father in February. His dad died tragically. His mom was battling breast cancer and has been able to battle that into remission. I mean, it could have been a very, very different story for him. He wound up having a triumph of a season, coming to Miami, and the great news he was returning, but now has to hobble off to the locker room here in the Cheez-It Bowl. With just under 4 minutes to go, and Oklahoma State on top 21-10. Time for a studio update. Let's toss it back to Matt Barrett.
Hey guys, good evening. You certainly don't want to see that in a bowl game. Coming up in the Capital One Halftime Report, can the Buckeyes get their revenge coming up against Clemson in the college football playoff? Plus, Devontae Smith makes a little history, and we'll preview tonight's Alamo Bowl, Texas and Colorado. We've got a nightcap. It's going to be fun. Jesse Palmer, Joey Galloway join me coming up on the Capital One Halftime Report.
Hey, Matt, thank you very much. So the Cowboys take over on offense. We have stalled a little bit here, and Miami coming to life on the defensive side. Esther Jade Silvera, the junior out of Pembroke Pines, Florida, with some emotion, and they lose two on that play. Second down and 12. Sanders has had a great night. Spencer Sanders, a Cowboy quarterback, came out firing. Jackson in the backfield, pressure on the quarterback. The football is loose, and Oklahoma State comes away with it. Harvey coming off that end spot and brought some serious heat.
They sure did. This is basically a race to the quarterback, bring some pressure. It's Jafari Harvey who's filling in for Jalen Phillips, and they feel like he's got natural pass rush speed, does a good job of dipping that shoulder, getting low and getting to the quarterback, and Oklahoma State fortunate that Logan Carter was there to fall on the football.
So third and 20 as the Cowboys are backed up. 28 sacks, number 16 in FBS this season for Miami. On a run, it's Richardson, I should say Jackson, as a hole opens up for Dez Jackson. Urban Hall with the tackle. That'll gain five.
You wonder, Dave, how Miami's going to handle this drive with Derek King not available. You know, how comfortable are they in a two-minute situation with Nikosi Perry?
The Cowboys forced to punt for the first time in this game, a fourth and 15. And Tom Hutton, a 30-year-old true sophomore from Australia, as he will launch this one. Harley bobbles it. Miami with the scramble at Oklahoma State. We'll see who came away with that. Both sides indicating they have the football. Now Miami is, as they take him off the pile. Another loose football as Harley bobbled it. And Oklahoma State will have the football. So Miami with a special teams mistake. And Harley Jr., usually very sure-handed, but he gave it away.
And this is brutal. It's just a fair catch. Should be there, and he just bobbles it. And then looks like Tecori Couch maybe has a chance to fall on it, but his momentum takes him past the football. If your defense has a great stop, the special teams blunder, put your defense in a really tough situation now on a short field.
So Sanders and the Cowboys get it back. On top, 21-10 here in the Cheez-It Bowl. They're going to bring some more pressure. Sanders evades that. He's going to fire long. One at Presley again. Good coverage there by DJ Ivy on the pass play.
That's close to being a phenomenal play by Spencer Sanders. See him climb in the pocket, all types of traffic around him. And that was a long throw from the right hash on a corner route to Presley.
Sanders, a former Mr. Texas football, highly recruited. Had offers from Ohio State, Texas A&M, Penn State, lots of schools. On his feet, and he will go out of bounds with 1:31 to go here in the first half. Well, it started out all Cowboys, Sanders having a great night. But Miami, even with the loss of their quarterback, and a huge loss indeed, able to nudge back into the game. Third down and 10 coming up. Oklahoma State trying to take advantage of the turnover. Sanders looking downfield, and the fire incomplete. He has not had many of those tonight, that's for sure.
He was looking for Tylan Wallace, and basically there was a rotation to Wallace. They essentially doubled him. It almost looks like Spencer Sanders is saying to Wallace, like, hey, I thought you were doing something else. A little bit of a miscommunication. Why he had to throw the football away.
Well, Miami with back-to-back defensive stands. And this time it's Gervin Hall back to receive the punt for the Hurricanes. And Hutton with a short punt, and at the 10-yard line, the Miami drive will begin with 1:20 to go, 31 yards on the kick. Well, coming up tomorrow, the Duke's Mayo Bowl. Wake Forest taking on Wisconsin. Then at 8, the first of the New Year's six. Heisman finalist Kyle Trask leading number 7 Florida against number 6 Oklahoma in the Cotton Bowl.
It's kind of remarkable when you see Kyle Trask, you realize that he wasn't even a starter in high school. What he's done at Florida, you know, playing behind Derek King in high school. Certainly had a heck of a college career.
Perry, backup quarterback, gets the pass away to Chaney. Chaney, good wheels taken to that sideline, chased up by Kristen Holmes. Staying on Kyle Trask now. 4,100 passing yards, the most in FBS, 43 touchdowns 43.
That's like a career for a lot of guys. Just, and again, without being a starter in high school, and it certainly meant a lot for Florida season.
Barry winding up, throwing long and almost caught, and should have been caught. D. Wiggins had it in his hands, an underthrown ball. He should have made the play.
And the underthrown go route is so hard for defenders to play. As you just see, Wiggins knows where the football is, comes back to it, does a good job of that. Bernard Converse kind of gets out of position. That's right in the hands of D. Wiggins. Big 6'3" wide receiver should have come down with that one.
Got to make that play. Miami's certainly not playing it safe here with Perry as the backup. Second down, 10. Gets it off short here to Pope, and Pope will be tied up. And once again, Rodriguez there to make the stop. It goes for 2 yards.
And Dave, you get some of these wide receiver screens, things like that, things that Oklahoma State is very familiar with defending. See the way they can rally to the football. Now, I do think you've got to be a little bit more careful here. As you see Miami slowing it down on 3rd and 8. With just over 30 seconds left to play in the half.
Well, you've got to wonder how the Hurricanes can bounce back, you know, mentally after the loss of a terrific quarterback in De'Ara King, who's been their leader all season long. On the slant, that's going to be a completed pass to Harley. Mike Harley, who had 10 catches, 170 yards against Virginia in October. And also hit him on an 89-yard touchdown pass against Duke. There's 7 seconds left here. And this season, for every field goal and extra point made by participating universities, Allstate will make a contribution to the university's general scholarship fund. Thank you, Allstate. A timeout, Oklahoma State. And head coach Mike Gundy, the former star quarterback at OSU. His name is still very prominent in the Cowboy record books. His team on top, 21-10, Oklahoma State.
Please reset the game clock to 14 seconds.
You see the game clock go to a reset of 14 seconds.
I was a little bit surprised that he didn't call a timeout when it was 3rd and 8.
3rd and 8, right.
You know, and you saw Miami slowing it down. Obviously would have given yourself a little bit more of a chance. Clearly call one here to force Miami to punt, but thought he maybe would have been a little bit more aggressive, especially with Miami getting the ball to start the second half.
And Headley will punt this one, and it's gonna bounce on out of bounds. So just a few seconds left here in the first half. Headley is quite a character. We talk about all the tattoos. One of those on his arm is of a UFO abducting a cow. He actually owned a tattoo parlor. Then worked as a scaffolder hundreds of feet in the air. He's really turned out to be quite a story at Miami. He's turned what was a big negative into a huge positive, the Miami punting game, and he's done it with flair.
He has done with flair. You mentioned his size before as well. Certainly a weapon for the Hurricanes.
So that is the end of the first half here at the Cheez-It Bowl. Oklahoma State leading Miami 21-10. We toss it back to the studio. Matt Barry and our all-star crew.
You know what? I probably wouldn't anoint them all-stars. I just think they're a couple of good guys. Welcome into the Capital One Halftime Report. All-star number one, Jesse Palmer. Joey Galloway still can't find his way on an airplane. I am Matt Barry. Happy to have you with us tonight. Doubleheader in college football bowl games. We want to start with the De'Ara King injury, Jess. You just hate to see it out of a player who earlier this week announced he was coming.
Yeah, you do. And thoughts and prayers certainly go out to De'Ara King and his family on this one. And remember, he tore the meniscus in that same right knee back in 2018 at Houston. As you mentioned, Matt, he's already said he's coming back next year. Let's just hope and pray that if he can't return in this game in the second half, Joey, he can rehab here, come back healthy for next season, because he really is one of the best players in all of college football.
He realized that Miami's offense finally got a little something going there in the second quarter, because they looked dead in the first quarter and woke up had the big offensive play and got things going, and all of a sudden you have this injury, and hopefully this team can go in, regroup at halftime, and come out ready to play in the third quarter.
And Katie George, the reporter in this game, if there's any info, they will certainly pass it along in the second half. As for the first half, things went Oklahoma State's way early. Spencer Sanders was slinging it all over the yard. That Pokes offense looked good.
And we knew this was going to happen because, of course, the Pokes are predominantly a running team, and Miami just gave up 554 rushing yards against UNC. And so number three comes out slinging the pill, and outside of the second play of the game and a ball that should have been picked, this is the best I've seen Spencer Sanders ever throw the football in college. He's been accurate, locating wide open receivers, making good decisions and reading coverage. And Joey, they're really taking advantage of the fact that Roche and Phillips aren't playing for this Miami defense.
Yeah, Blake Baker, the defensive coordinator for Miami, is going to have to make a decision in this game, whether he's going to start sending blitzes to get Spencer Sanders uncomfortable. I don't know if I've seen Spencer Sanders look this comfortable in a game all season long. He's just in the pocket. He's throwing his sidearm. Bowl games are supposed to be fun, and Spencer Sanders is having a lot of fun. Now Miami's going to have to make a decision. Are we going to let this guy sit here and pick us apart or start sending blitzes, start getting some hits, try to make him uncomfortable? They have to do something to slow down this Oklahoma State offense.
252 yards total offense for Oklahoma State in the first half, 205 of those through the air. Mm-hmm. They're certainly doing whatever they want, Spencer Sanders.
Welcome back to Capital One Bowl Mania.
Welcome back to the Cheez-It Bowl here in Orlando as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. Getting ready for the second half between Oklahoma State and Miami. The Cowboys with a 21-10 lead over the Hurricanes will have the ball. Miami will to begin the second half, but they will not have their outstanding quarterback, De'Ara King. He was injured late in the first half. Dave O'Brien, Tim Hasselbeck with you. What a tremendous blow for Miami. And, you know, given everything that's happened with the players opting out all over the country, Tim, this is a guy who elected to stay. He announced he was returning next year. It was great news there in Coral Gables. And then this injury in the final minutes of the first half.
Yeah, it felt like playing in this game was going to be a bridge to next season. There was so much excitement about it. And Miami's battling back, down 21-0. And it feels like, you know, a little bit of the wind out of their sails with the De'Ara King injury. But Nikosi Perry started 9 games in his career. Let's see what he can do for this Hurricane offense.
So underway here in the second half, Mike Harley's going to take it out. And Harley looking for some open spaces, finally dragged down hard. And a flag on the play here in the first 7 seconds of the second half with Oklahoma State in charge 21-10. And if you did miss it, if you were not with us at the time, we will replay that injury to De'Ara King.
Personal foul, horse collar tackle, kicking team number 4. 15-yard penalty from the end of the return, first down.
Here's a look at what happened to King.
And it's hard to tell, Dave, if it's on that plant there with his right leg or when Trey Sterling makes contact with his quad. But clearly it was enough to take him off the field, not really under his own power, and that was hard to see. Just as a fan of college football and De'Ara King's, and well, for that Hurricane sideline.
Cozy Perry coming on there at the tail end of the half. So trying to lead the Hurricanes back and hand off to Donald Chaney. We just pray for the best. We have not had an update. No injury news on King to this point as that carry goes for 3 yards. He really has been one of the best stories in the ACC this year. And again, some more trickery on a long pass by Perry. He's got a man. Incomplete, in and out of the hands of Mark Pope.
This was a really nice job by Nikosi Perry. It's a flea flicker. The pitch back to him is low. That's a bad spot for a quarterback to be in. You know, to be fielding a ground ball on a flea flicker. And he does a good job of getting this out there, re-gripping it. Now Mark Pope's got to come up with that one. That ball tad underthrown, but that needs to be caught. That's a second big drop by Miami.
And D. Wiggins had one in the first half. Flag here. Another one to begin the second half in Orlando.
Offside. Defense number one. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
And you almost wondered why here didn't get a free play. Like, to me, this didn't look unabated to the quarterback initially. But good job of Perry using the snap count. I would say this about Nkosi Perry. He's not nearly the same runner, so you're not going to have the design runs that you have with Derek King. But there's other things, probably just as a passer, where he's certainly going to be comfortable.
Going to throw short to the tight end Mallory, trying to spin away. Stopped by Tanner McAllister after a 6-yard pickup. You mentioned his history. You know, 6-3 as a starter. Perry throwing for 22 touchdown passes, 10 interceptions throughout the course of his career. Not a factor this season because King became such a big star. First down and 10. Time to throw and complete. That'll be caught by Jordan as he is dragged out by Trey Sterling.
When they run the fake wide receiver screen to get the defense to jump up, you see the pursuit that's going to Mike Harley, and then Brevin Jordan just gets up the sideline. And Dave, I would just say, as we look at Nkosi Perry's numbers, it was a different offense. An offensive line that was not playing nearly as well.
Going to be broken up. Scheme. Intended for D. Wiggins. And Bernard Converse with the coverage for the Cowboys. So second down and 10. So Miami under new management. We'll see how this works out. You know, they usually want to go at warp speed. That's the way they've been doing it under King all season long. That's the offense as designed by Rhett Lashley. This has a very different looking and feeling tempo already behind Perry. Trailing 21 to 10. Out of the shotgun, pressure on him. He'll dump it and incomplete. Off of Wiggins again, couldn't handle it. He's having kind of a tough night.
This is a brutal drop because it is blitz zero. Rhett Lashley sees it pre-snap, and they're gonna get to a wide receiver screen. If Wiggins will catch it, they've got a hat for a hat, and that's gonna be a touchdown. That's the third brutal drop. That's a great play call in that situation by Rhett Lashley.
Wide receivers for the Hurricanes are not helping Perry, at least not yet. Third down and 10. The backup trying to fashion a drive here right off the bat in the second half for the Hurricanes. He will throw, and that's going to be out of bounds. The catch by Keyshawn Smith, who can really fly, a freshman they love, but incomplete.
And because it's into the boundary, they just run out of room. It's the right place with the football. And, you know, Keyshawn Smith wins. He just ran out of real estate with where Nkosi Perry put that football.
So Borregales on to attempt one from 40 yards. One of the best in college football, first team All-American this year. And that kick is up, and that kick is perfect. Miami scores first to begin the second half, 21-13, Cowboys. You're watching the Cheez-It Bowl from Orlando, Florida. Miami climbing back into this thing. Now 21-13 with 13:25 to go in the third. Let's toss it down to Katie George.
I just spoke with Miami's head athletic trainer, Vinny Scavo. De'Eriq King has a right leg injury and will not return to tonight's game. They will evaluate the injury further back in Miami when they return tomorrow afternoon.
All right, so obviously ruled out for the remainder of the game. Nkosi Perry has taken over at quarterback, and Tim, he looks like he might be able to move this team.
Yeah, I feel like I've seen enough to have the confidence, and it seems like they do as well, calling a flea flicker. Doing a good job, you know, passing the ball, and really should have had a touchdown pass if the screen wasn't dropped. So, yeah, I think that, you know, you don't have to look at this offensively as, you know, an inability to move the football without De'Eriq King.
On the goal line is Presley, who's had a big, big night catching passes. He's been sensational, a couple of touchdowns. Well, New Year's Day at noon Eastern on ESPN and the app. The Peach Bowl starts a huge college football Friday. Number 9, Georgia, taking on Desmond Ritter and undefeated, and number 8, Cincinnati.
How about the job Luke Fickell has done at Cincinnati? I mean, Cincinnati playing Georgia in a bowl game, just the job that he has done, and to be one of those coaches that every year the NFL is going to have interest, as well as other schools in college football. That's been really impressive.
And meanwhile, the Cowboy offense has stalled a little bit here after a really hot start. Spencer Sanders now giving this one off for Jackson, and Jackson will be chased for a loss by Jade Silvera. That's going to lose 4 yards.
And, you know, Manny Diaz said it, you know, around halftime. Basically, he was excited about how his defense has responded in some sudden change situations. He's done a good job after a slow start.
And Sanders going to be dragged down by Bradley Jennings. No place to hide for the Cowboy quarterback.
And they come after him. You see a little late getting lined up, and Bradley Jennings just fires his gun. He's able to get to Spencer Sanders and get him down.
Junior out of Jacksonville, Florida on the attack. Miami with 2 sacks. 3rd and 23. Cowboys continue to back up here. Miami grabbing momentum and doing it with the defense. Sanders gonna run it. And down he goes. He's looking at his hand. So just about 12 minutes to go in the third, he gains 12, but again, glancing at that right hand as he comes off on 4th down and 11, forcing another punt by Hutton. So we'll see if that hand will be something of a factor injury-wise for Sanders moving forward tonight. On the punt, Harley back in. This one he hangs on to. He had bobbled one and fumbled it away earlier. Flag down here, but you can see the blood on that right hand of Spencer Sanders. He just had a very quick 3 and out. 47-yard punt. 11:41 remaining in the third. And Miami with the football back in a conversation here.
During the kick, personal foul, blindside block, number 7, receiving team. 15-yard penalty from the end of the kick, first down.
Personal foul, we look at the Sanders injury as we go to break. Already seen the Miami star quarterback King knocked out of the game. We're in the third quarter here at the Cheez-It Bowl in Orlando. Well, they did a lot of work on their right hand of Spencer Sanders during the timeout. And Tim, looks like he may have gotten stepped on.
Yeah, listen, as a quarterback, your feet get stepped on quite a bit, but it's Harrison Hunt to 81. Watch him as he's pursuing to the quarterback right there.
Yep.
Step on the right hand of Spencer Sanders. And listen, not only, you know, I mean, obviously we saw him bleeding. He cut his hand. You know, hope that he didn't break any fingers or anything like that.
Yeah, that's 6'4", 285 coming down on your throwing hand. That's going to be a completed pass out to Mark Polk, who lunges ahead, picks up a first down, and a 12-yard gain. Let's get out of Katie.
Well, guys, Sanders has multiple cuts and gashes on his knuckles and fingers of that right hand. They put an ointment to stop the bleeding. He writhed in pain a couple of times because that ointment stung, but he did give a smile, said he's good to go. Thanks for the help.
All right, Katie, thank you very much.
So you know, Dave, quarterbacks are tough. I don't know if you knew that.
Yeah.
Really tough.
Some of them are very tough. You had that reputation. Old Ironsides. It's a long throw, and the play is going to be broken up. The intended receiver, Mike Harley. And a good job by Tanner McAllister. Another man down, this time for the Cowboys. That is going to be Brandon Evers. A big tackle, junior out of Bixby, Oklahoma. 6'2", 295 pounds. 21-13. Oklahoma State with the lead. Sanders, who got off to a tremendous start, slinging it all over the place. Offense has slowed down a little bit. Miami's back in the game. Coming up next on ESPN and the app, number 20 Texas taking on Colorado in the Valero Alamo Bowl. So more college football to come. And of course on Friday, college football playoffs, national semifinals at 4 o'clock. Number 1 Alabama against number 4 Notre Dame in the Rose Bowl. At 8 p.m., number 2 Clemson against number 3 Ohio State in the Sugar Bowl. Both of those games on ESPN. Miami trying to do it with a backup quarterback, stopped by Malcolm Rodriguez as he takes down Cheney. No gain on the rush. So, Tim, who are you taking in those two contests? Alabama, Notre Dame, Rose Bowl at 4 o'clock, game number 1.
You know, I like Alabama. I mean, just so good, so much speed. I think that would probably end up proving to be too much for Notre Dame. And, you know, Clemson, you know, I think of Trevor Lawrence. Well, I would agree with Dabo and that he's the best player in college football, and you can see the difference in how he's played, especially run the football in big games. I think that will end up being the difference there.
Fourth and 1, Miami to punt as Headley is out. By the way, his family watching in Australia.
Offense, 5-yard penalty.
Delay of game, 5 yards. Down. This game began at 6:30 in the morning Wednesday, but they're up and watching, and watching Lou punt the football, which he's done so well. In fact, a second team All-American, put down and 6.
Kind of like that idea, Dave, of right when you wake up, there being football to watch.
Yeah, that's right. You're right up your alley. I know it is.
I mean, what's better than that?
You're not lying.
We've seen football basically on every day of the week this year.
Miami called a timeout. Therefore, there is no delay of game foul. This will be the first charge timeout for Miami. This will be a 30-second timeout.
So no penalty and a timeout instead for Manny Diaz and the Hurricanes. Manny, the son of a former Miami mayor, has an awful lot to be excited about as he prepares for 2021. So they called a timeout. Are they going to go for it here?
Yeah, you know, I almost think, like, if you're not, it was a silly timeout because, you know, the way your defense is playing, if you weren't going for it on fourth down, you know, I'm not really sure what you were doing. It's a one-score game right now. The timeout could end up being valuable. It does look like Brett Lashley is talking to his offense. So now all of a sudden the timeout makes a little bit more sense.
And Perry back out there, the quarterback. Fourth and 1. Now, of course, this would almost be an automatic many times for King when he was in there at the quarterback spot. Going to hand it off here for Harris. And Harris churning ahead for a first down for the Hurricanes.
That was close, but you see why Harris is their short yardage runner, and all of a sudden Manny Diaz, they're paying off that timeout, keeping this drive alive.
Miami with 13 unanswered points after falling behind 21-0. Hand off to Harley, and he's sprinting ahead, and he'll pick up another first down. They hand off to the senior wide receiver from Fort Lauderdale, who has scored 6 touchdowns this season, a first down.
And you can see how the run game looks different with Nikosi Perry at quarterback. You know, rarely do they do that with Harley when King can be the runner, but Trey's trying to get more speed in the backfield is why they bring Harley in as a ball carrier.
Miami on the move. Perry will step up. He's going to run it before they drag him down from behind. Stopped by Brock Martin. But he will pick up 4 yards on that carry. Brett Lashley, his first year as the offensive coordinator for Miami. He's really been one of the major success stories for this program this season. Here comes Harris. He's free across the 20, cutting to the sideline. He is in for a touchdown. Cam Harris for the score. A 42-yard touchdown rumble. And here come the Canes. 21-19 as they keep on coming at the Cowboys.
Well, it's just split zone. They bring the tight end across the formation and just finds a crease. And Cam Harris, who I mentioned before, is a powerful back, but he's got excellent speed as well. And that's a good job in the open field. And how about the Miami Hurricanes fighting back and doing it with their backup quarterback now going for two to try to tie this one up?
Harris had not been a big factor until that scintillating run for the touchdown. Tight end trying to move forward. He broke the tackle, diving for the end zone, and a two-point conversion. So Miami all the way back from 21-0 down, and on the conversion, they tie the game at 21. Rev and Jordan with the score.
Well, how about the Hurricanes punching back?
The previous play is under further review.
First, the big run with Cam Harris. You see the speed in the open field. Good job of Pope blocking downfield. Just an excellent job of getting movement, an excellent job of just getting upfield by Cam Harris. And then on the two-point play, what an outstanding effort on the bubble screen by Brevin Jordan. Really nothing there, except for just an outstanding effort by the big tight end. You see that right knee down, if you kind of time him up to see. I think there's a pretty good chance, Dave, that this crosses the goal line before that knee is down, and with it being, you know, called a good conversion on the field, I don't see enough to overturn this.
And that's the key. Otherwise, they stick with the call on the field, which was a two-point conversion for Miami. As we two-box it.
Yeah, and, you know, that angle there, because we're not right down the goal line, you know, maybe looks like it's not across it, but I think if we were, you know, directly across it, I think it would be there. And as I said, there's got to be enough to overturn the call on the field. Either way, how about the effort by Brevin Jordan?
Yeah.
Because there really was nothing there. I think initial contact is made at about the 3-yard line.
So here's the lunge using all of 6'3". Do they have enough evidence to overturn that? Will the two-point conversion on the field? This is a long look, too.
But see how we're looking at it from in the end zone.
Sure.
And I think that, you know, that perspective, you know, is a little tricky.
After further review, the ball carrier was short of the goal line. Before the try is no good.
So the call has been reversed. Take the 2 points away. Now 21-19, Oklahoma State. Brevin Jordan denied on the review.
And clearly, you know, clearly I didn't see it the same way the review officials did. You know, he obviously thinks that he was in. As I said, it's an amazing effort. I just don't think that we were looking straight down the goal line, and without looking straight down the goal line,
can you review it? Can you reverse it? Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it was too close at that point, but nonetheless, still Miami fighting back.
Yeah, 19 unanswered points for the Hurricanes. And the Cowboys searching for their offense, which was red hot for a big chunk of that first half, but has really cooled down. Presley, who's been their hot hand, And he takes a pretty good hit. Good coverage there by the Hurricanes on special teams. As he returns it for 15, we take a look at the Bowl Challenge Cup now. The standings brought to you by Progressive. Mountain West 2-0. Sunbelt at 4-1. ACC playing here tonight with Carolina also on the docket. So last time we saw Spencer Sanders, he was nursing an injured right hand, which was bruised and bleeding. Let's see how he reacts. Pretty good on the first one as he got that pass to Martin. Martin trying to move away from the tacklers, and there's a flag down on the play. Bubba Bolden tying him up eventually, but a flag. 15-yard pickup there for Martin. But a penalty. .826 to go in the third. And suddenly a very tight game here in the Cheez-It Bowl.
Block in the back. Offense number 87. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Still first down.
You see Logan Carter, 87 right there, is just kind of pursuing, good hustle, trying to make a play. And, you know, as Tay Martin gets up the field, you know, they get him for a block in the back. I'm not sure I saw it the same way. Tough break for Oklahoma State offensively, though, after a nice play to get his drive started.
First down, 13, and the pass going to be intercepted. On the deflection, Miami with the pick, Bradley Jennings. And the Hurricanes force a turnover. A flag down, however. We've had a bunch of those here in the second half already. A flag down.
Pass interference. Defense number 23. The ball replaced at the spot of the foul with an automatic first down.
To Corey Couch. They throw the flag on Couch, who's had a very, very big night, but Manny thought it was tipped.
Yeah, Manny's saying the ball is tipped, but Couch is down at the bottom of the screen on Tay Martin. I think Manny's trying to say that Zach McLeod maybe got a finger on it. It was hard for me to tell if he did. So it looks like Couch is there early. And
Brown with a big carry gets out to the 30-yard line before Gervin Hall makes the stop, but another flag.
Holding, offense number 70. 10-yard penalty, first down.
Now we're going to go back to remember Manny Diaz thought it was tipped on the interception. Take a look at this.
Well, there's Zach McLeod. And if he gets his hand on that, then it can't be P.I. Yeah, it can't be P.I. by Corey Couch. And so I think Manny Diaz got a pretty good case there.
I think he's right.
And that would mean it would be Miami's ball. That's a tough break for Miami and a really good play by McLeod and Jennings.
I don't think there's much question that was tipped. Brown with another carry, but dragged down. Good stop there by Jennings again. A two-point game here in Orlando.
Dave, how about this Miami defense? Without your two best pass rushers, your two best defensive players continuing to fight like this.
Sanders finding a hole. It's going to be cut back inside. He's going to lose the football, but recovered by Oklahoma State. Bubba Bolden took him down and upended him. And the scamper will get him a healthy gain. Third down and six.
And this one was close. That's a good job by Bubba Bolden, just getting his arm out and kind of swiping at Spencer Sanders' leg to get him down. Clearly down before that ball came out. Critical third down here.
Martin in motion. Sanders to fire to him right at the 30-yard line. And trying to move the sticks here. And Oklahoma State able to do that. and pick up another first down.
You know, what Oklahoma State does is they motion Tate Martin to get off coverage to get a free access throw.
Big hole for Brown straight ahead for another first. But quite a recovery here by the Cowboys, Tim, when it was, you know, first and 20.
Yeah, I mean, it was a penalty, a backwards, you know, part of your drive. You get a fortunate call on what would have been an interception, and now all of a sudden feels like you're playing downhill with some momentum.
Martin with a catch and drags a tackler with him. He was dragging Couch with him to pick up a first, a 10-yard gain. Boy, they are going at warp speed, aren't they?
They are, and you have to wonder. You know, it's a bit of a break, you know, between your last regular season game and the bowl game, and you try to let your players enjoy the process. It should be a reward, not a punishment. You wonder the conditioning that they're in to play at this pace.
Another first down for Sanders. Handing off for Richardson. Trying the center of the line, stopped by Sam Brooks. A gain of two. Talking with Coach Gundy this week, and he said, yeah, I wanted my guys to enjoy this time of the year. He sent them home for Christmas. A lot of programs this time of the year are not doing that. Wanted to make sure that they got a chance to see their loved ones. That pass is going to be broken up, but another flag is down. Intended for Martin, but Couch is going to argue the flag. Another penalty coming.
Pass interference. Defense number 23. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul with an automatic first down.
Again, it's Tate Martin onto Corey Couch at the bottom of your screen, and just man coverage, a lot of contact, and it's that little tug at the top of the route, and you see, you know, the coaching staff for Oklahoma State calling for it. But Corey Couch got a lot of speed. I think he's the best corner Miami has. A couple of tough ones here.
Richardson, freshman out of Oklahoma City. And a stop by Bolden after a 3-yard pickup. And De'Ara King is back on the field. Had right leg in a brace and on crutches, but he's returned. Sanders airing it out. And a diving attempt, but incomplete. Stoner, the intended receiver. Eric King injured in the first half and refused to get on a cart even though they made the offer, and absolutely determined he walked off the field with some help, but obviously quite hobbled. We just hope it's something he can bounce back from quickly. Third down and seven. Yeah, it is very good to see him out there. Miami has continued to play pretty darn well without him. Sanders to throw. Diving attempt and the catch made by Tate Martin. A sensational grab.
It's a great catch. It's also an outstanding route. It's man coverage. It just basically whips back out of this route. The ball's thrown a little bit, you know, outside. Great concentration.
Round tough run. L.D. Brown, who missed the previous three games because of injury, he'll pick up six. They're delighted to have him back. Another man down here for Miami. And that's Cam Williams, the big freshman defensive end, who is filling in for Quincy Roche, who is one of the two outstanding ends for Miami, who have opted out. Now, back to that first half, if you did not see it. Last 4 minutes or so of the opening half, the outstanding quarterback for Miami on this play. Hard to tell if it happened on the plant or when he was upended, because he did take a pretty good hit on that right leg.
Yeah, it's too hard to tell, but what was clear was he had a hard time putting some weight on it, went into the tent. You know, the trainers did call for the cart, and he kind of hobbled his way off the field. I will say it's nice to see him out of the field. Looks like he's putting a little bit of pressure on, you know, that right leg, and that's all coming on the heels of a big announcement he made that he was going to be returning to Miami for another year, and there's just so much optimism about what that was going to mean for the program in this game and then going forward to next season.
Sanders on second down and four for the Cowboys. Handing off with Jackson. Jackson did not find room to maneuver. Cowboys offense had gotten hot there for a while, but this loses 3 yards.
And I will tell you, Tay Martin seems to be the guy.
Martin, the senior. Presley gets the handoff. He's been such a difference maker. Did not get to the marker, but another flag is down. And from that angle, it's been a sloppy second half. We had a lot of penalties, really, on both sides.
Personal foul, force collar tackle, number 26 defense. Half the distance to the goal from the end of the run, and an automatic first down.
He's on Durbin Hall.
Durbin Hall's pursuing Presley, who's got so much speed, and now when you're on the nameplate and you bring him down immediately, still know that he was behind him.
These penalties for Miami really aiding the Cowboys in a huge way on this particular drive. And now all the way down to the sixth, first and goal for the Cowboys. There have been three penalties on Miami on this drive alone.
Timeout, Oklahoma State. Their
take
first
a timeout.
30-second timeout.
Oklahoma State takes, when we talk about, you know, how he has triumphed in what was a very difficult year for the King family. Tragically losing his father. His dad passed away back in February, so did not get a chance to see his son do all these great things in Miami. His mom, Cassandra, cancer-free, declared in July, ringing that bell. She's got a great laugh, too. And so proud of her son. Earl Campbell Award finalist. He has been one of the top quarterbacks in all of college football this season. He declared last week that he will return and play another year to take advantage of the eligibility rules in college football. Everybody can return. This year will not count against your eligibility. So you're just hoping and praying that that leg will allow him to do that.
It seems like they like him just as much as a guy as they do a player.
Yes, right. That's what those pictures tell you. Exactly. Mm-hmm. Well, Miami with another big stop. This one, Bubba Bolden coming up and saying hello as he makes the stop, forcing a 3-yard loss here for the Cowboys.
Yeah. Miami did a nice job of holding their pressure there. Looked like they were maybe going to get some coverage, and then here comes the blitz, and when you try to run right into the teeth of a blitz, and Bolden there to make the play.
Second and goal. Stoner in motion. Sanders to roll. Looking for the end zone, and incomplete. Nothing developed there for Sanders.
And they get him again to the pressure. Blake Baker
is outside the pocket, the ball across the line of scrimmage.
Has basically decided we're going to come after you in this situation. Certainly not going to let you just run it down our throat. And it might have something to do with the fact that we haven't seen Tylon Wallace out there in quite some time. He's not on the field now.
One of the best wide receivers in the country, but Miami has really made it pretty much a non-factor. Going to float that one for the corner and contact there. Another stop intended for Martin.
Well, it's man coverage. See, Martin's trying to come down with his football, and ball's kind of left inside, and it's all out pressure again. Blake Baker, I think, has decided with no Tylon Wallace on the field that he feels really good about bringing heat and playing man coverage.
26-yard attempt here for Cole to try and get the Cowboys back on the scoreboard, and he'll stick it. So they do get some points, and it's 24-19 Oklahoma State. But if you're Manny Diaz in Miami, you don't mind that. with your best player out at the moment. Look at the timeline on De'Aaron King now, coming from Houston. 2018, 2019, redshirting after four games, then the transfer to Miami. Everybody thought it was just going to be 1 year. But announcing his return for another season at Miami just after Christmas.
And it's been interesting to hear, you know, people in the program talk about their belief in what they can do, like what's possible for Miami when he's the quarterback. I feel like they always just feel like they can win when he's there. I mean, you see the production, how talented he is, and he's also a leader, kind of a contagious leader for Miami. Let's hope it's a quick recovery for him.
Harley to take it out on the kickoff return, and that's where the drive will begin for the Hurricanes. College football semifinals. New Year's Day on ESPN. Number one Alabama taking on number four Notre Dame. That's the Rose Bowl at four. And then number two Clemson and number three Ohio State in the Sugar Bowl. Winners play for the national championship on January 11 right here on ESPN.
I like the game cast ability too, to watch it so many different ways. Pretty cool opportunity to do that. That's four really good football teams.
So Perry back to throw again. And a short one here to Harley. Harley with some room after picking up the first down. But it's a 20-yard gain to him.
Yeah, Nikosi Perry, I mean, the box score is going to show he's 7 for 15 right now, but you consider some of those drops on the flea flicker and the wide receiver screen. I think you have to be really happy with how Nikosi Perry has come off the bench.
There have been three big drops for Miami from the wide receiver core in the game. Another completion. Got this one out into the flat. Harper to take down Wiggins. Coming up on about 2 minutes to go here in the third, here in the Cheez-It Bowl. Second down and three. And it's going to be fumbled. And Oklahoma State has it. Miami fumbles it away. And it's the second turnover of the ball game for the Canes.
Yes, I've been really impressed with him as a passer. This is the stuff you probably don't with the freshman Cheney at running back, and he's trying to pull it, I believe. And on the pull, it just loses the football, and Brock Martin, just one of those defensive linemen, always seems to be in the right spot.
So the Cowboys take over. Sanders will fire incomplete. Once again, looking for Presley. Talking about Tylan Wallace being a very quiet guy so far in this game, and what a great wide receiver he has been. All Big 12 first team this season. He was an All-American a couple of years ago. Will he become a bigger factor the rest of the way for the Cowboys? Second down and 10. He's going to throw it deep and again incomplete, and a flag once again. Is that going to be Couch again for the Hurricanes? There's just so many flags here on Miami.
Pass interference, defense number 23, 15-yard penalty, and an automatic first down.
And Corey Couch.
You know, Miami plays a lot of man. There's definitely some contact. This ball doesn't seem to be anywhere near Martin, and I don't know.
Yeah, and on that last drive, two pass interferences against Miami and a personal foul. Eventually, Oklahoma State settling for a field goal. This one goes for no gain. And a minute 38 to go here in the third quarter. Still not seeing Wallace in the game as Sanders will run it. He takes off across the 20 and picks up a first down. Smith dragging him down, but a big gain of 16. Let's go down to Katie.
Well, guys, Tylan Wallace has not played a snap throughout this second half. He's on the sidelines currently without his helmet. I'm told by OSU staff that it is not a medical issue. It's a player decision to stay on the sidelines.
Okay, I'd love to know what that means. First down and 10. Presley has really been the star receiver. He's open again, and he's gonna make the catch. Low toss, but a fine play. Presley's really been outstanding.
He has been outstanding. They motion him across the formation, get him off coverage with that motion, and then he just kind of comes underneath the wake of another receiver's release. It's a good job of going down for the ball. Remember down here last time, Miami just decided to all-out blitz three plays in a row. Not be surprised to see him just continue to do that here, especially with no Wallace.
Right, Brown on the carry. So brings up first and goal here for Oklahoma State as they lead it by 5 against number 18 Miami. And that's the end of the third quarter. Well, Miami has been trying to come back all night. They were down 21-0. They've lost their quarterback. Let's see if they can do it. Oklahoma State on the drive at the moment behind Spencer Sanders, but the Miami defense and the offense has been a bigger star here. On to the fourth quarter. Hey, New Year's Day at noon Eastern on ESPN and the app, the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl starts a huge college football Friday. Number 9, Georgia, taking on undefeated at number 8, Cincinnati. Back here at the Cheez-It Bowl in Orlando, pretty night. And heading off to the fourth quarter, which Oklahoma State will play without their outstanding wide receiver, Tylan Wallace, as Katie George said. It's not an injury situation. It's not a health situation. He's not going to play. It's a player decision, his decision not to play the rest of the game.
Yeah, it's a little surprising to see this during a game, you know, and that's, I think, you know, it's probably tricky for a coaching staff to deal with, for the players that are relying on a player to deal with. You know, it's become normal for guys to opt out, you know, of a bowl game that have an NFL future. Tylan Wallace certainly has an NFL future.
You see that outstanding sophomore year that he had. This season numbers down a little bit. He's missed some time, hadn't played since December 5th. You know, you made the point that, you know, maybe you've shown people that you're healthy. You can go out there and hate to cast aspersions on anybody, but it's first and goal here for Oklahoma State as we start the fourth. 24-19 Cowboys looking to get it into the end zone again. Sanders handing off for Jackson. Sanders has had a very impressive night, throwing it 248 yards, 2 touchdowns. That carry got them nothing.
Miami's made it really clear. They're going to all out everything. They're going to have everyone up in the box. You got Corey Couch isolated on Dylan Stoner at the bottom of the screen. Would not be surprised if Couch's, you know, pass interference call so far, if Oklahoma State tests that.
Second and goal, time for the end zone. Stoner, he's going to get in for the touchdown. We've seen a number of these in this game, really on both sides. Great second efforts after the catch to find the end zone, and Oklahoma State goes up 30-19.
Well, this is what I was talking about. They got everyone up in there to stop the run, and Stoner is isolated on Couch at the bottom of the screen. He just does a good job of being patient with his release, selling outside to get his body inside, and then he's strong enough to get into the end zone. You know, a lot of man coverage for Miami. Dylan Stoner gets the best of that matchup.
Sanders with his third touchdown pass here in the Cheez-It Bowl. And the extra point is good, 31-19. Stoner with the extra effort. Spencer Sanders, he has been outstanding in this one.
The Cheez-It Bowl, brought to you by Cheez-It. Cheesy, crunchy bowl season satisfaction.
Well, you're watching the Cheez-It Bowl as part of Capital One Bowl Mania. Fourth quarter, big score for the Cowboys as they lead it now 31-19. Tim Hasselbeck from his home in Nashville, Dave O'Brien from Bristol, Connecticut, Katie George there on the field in Orlando. Very kind of you to join us. And of course, the college football playoff national semifinals coming up on Friday at 4 o'clock, Bama and Notre Dame. In the Rose Bowl at 8, Clemson and Ohio State in the Sugar Bowl. Miami looking to answer now. Harley evading one man. And now the Hurricanes with the backup quarterback, Cozy Perry. And Tim, you talk about Alabama, number one in the country, taking on number four Notre Dame. You like Bama in game number one. Game two, though, the Sugar Bowl, Clemson and Ohio State. And we know how Dabo Swinney felt about Ohio State and whether they should be in the top four, because he had him number 11 in his poll. But your thoughts on that game at 8 o'clock?
Well, didn't he say he could run for governor of Michigan?
Yes,
is that what he said?
and win in a runaway, he thought. Yeah.
Yeah. Two really good football teams. I do like Dabo's squad in that one.
I know how much you are fond of Trevor Lawrence, having covered him a bunch the last couple of years. Flag down here. 14:08 to go, fourth quarter in Orlando. Man, the second half has been dominated by the flags.
Personal foul, blocking below the waist. Defense, number 24. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run and an automatic first down.
See your 24 at the top of your screen. A lot of times what little guys do when they're faced with big guys, that you can't do it in that situation, kind of don't blame Bernard Converse on that one.
Perry, pressure on him, and he throws it right into the grass. Incomplete. Good pressure there by Devin Harper on Perry. So second down and 10 coming up for Miami. They really had the offense moving. Even without De'Eric King, Perry had been doing a good job. Seen a lot of penalties. I mean, Miami, five of them in the second half. That one darted in for a completion over the middle. The catch made by Mike Harley.
Yeah, and I think generally speaking, Dave, we mentioned the drops. Obviously, had the fumbled exchange with Chaney, but I think Perry's done a nice job. And I think Rhett Lashley's done a nice job because the quarterback run game has changed with Perry in at quarterback.
Yeah, very, very dramatically there. You know, King, you're talking about a guy who rushed for over 500 yards, more than any quarterback ever has in Miami. Perry trying to step up this time and spin, but no, sir. Trey Sterling with the stop. Once again, he's had a really good night.
He has. I think the front for Oklahoma State has done a nice job as well, and Sterling comes flying up in there. And it's a little bit what I mean about the quarterback run game. Actually try, you know, a quarterback lead. And you think about teams that Oklahoma State faces, you know, Texas, Kansas State, Iowa State, TCU. You see a lot of quarterback runs, and I don't know if it's what you want to do with Perry.
Step up and out of the lob, and he has the tight end, Mallory. Mallory tripped up just shy of the goal line. Devin Harper saving a touchdown. Otherwise, Mallory is celebrating.
Yeah, this basically looks like quarterback run. You see Trey Sterling come flying up in there, but it's really to draw the secondary players in they hit Mallory on the little pop pass.
Bring up first and goal. That play went for 45.
Timeout. Oklahoma State, their second of the second half.
So the Cowboys with a timeout. Miami knocking on the door.
What a great play design by Rhett Lashley. Will Mallory is in the backfield. I believe he's being covered in man-to-man by Trey Sterling. Sterling thinks that Mallory is just a lead blocker on a quarterback draw and lets him basically escape out of the backfield. And that's how he gets so wide open for that big game. And then it's a good job of the rest of the Oklahoma State defense rallying to prevent a tackle. But they had run a quarterback draw on a previous play, kind of a quarterback lead play. And I think Trey Sterling thought they were coming back with it.
Harry, several times we have noticed with that little jab step and then back to throw, that play went for 44 yards. So first and goal for Miami. And right to the back, trying to dive ahead. That's Harris on the snap and close to the goal line.
Yeah, and it's a direct snap. They have Nikosi Perry, you know, out at wide receiver, probably a little far back for Harris to dive into the end zone, but let's make this one closer.
Second and goal. Low snap again. Again, that jab step, lobs it up, and a tough catch for a touchdown by Jordan. Brevin Jordan making the grab in the end zone. And the Canes refuse to go away.
It's similar to the big play we saw earlier to Mallory where they faked the quarterback run. It's kind of their version of the play action here. And you know, Brevin Jordan, I believe, is getting interfered with. Rodriguez is holding that right arm. Eric King on crutches.
Now wearing 82.
He's enjoying it.
Yeah.
As is Bubba Bolden.
Saying, yes, sir. You're exactly right. I mean, Tim, that was a one-handed catch because the other hand was getting tied down. Got an injured player down here for Miami. Jared Williams, 6'6", 308, now on his feet. Good sign there for the Canes. The right tackle, Jordan with a terrific play. You know, it's a game where we have seen five or six really brilliant offensive plays. And here's another one by Brevin Jordan.
Yeah, Brevin Jordan coming out of the backfield. It's almost like power pass, you know, where you're trying to look like you're pouring it up in there and you leak somebody out to the flat. It's Brevin Jordan in this case. He gets interfered with. There should have been a flag regardless of the great catch by Brevin Jordan. And it's a really tough throw to make down in that situation. Great touch by Nikosi Perry, who again, I think has done a phenomenal job coming off the bench in relief for the injured Derek King. What a throw, what a catch.
Jordan, by the way, with a touchdown catch from each quarterback for Miami tonight. The extra point makes it 31-26. Well, here's the first of the New Year's Six games, a top 10 matchup. Heisman finalist Kyle Trask leading number 7 Florida against number 6 Oklahoma in the Goodyear Cotton Bowl Classic. Coverage beginning tomorrow at 8 o'clock Eastern on ESPN and the app. So 12 minutes to go. Still anybody's game. Look at all the offense for Miami all of a sudden, and that's without their number 1 quarterback for a big hunk of the game. And Brevin Jordan with a one-handed catch in the end zone as King's teammates continue to come up to him one after another and say hello and express their sympathy on the injury, but they're trying to come back and win a game. They were down in 21-0.
Dave, I think there can be a lift to that. And the guy who's the leader of your football team, who everyone knows is injured, it was hard to see him go off the field. I think there can be a lift when he comes back on the sideline. I think it's a sign of leadership and toughness, and well, it looks like it on Miami's sideline right now.
12 minutes to go, 31-26, Oklahoma State. Let's get it back to the studio and Matt Barry.
Guys, good evening. You've got a good one brewing there in the fourth quarter. When it goes final, we've got the Valero Alamo Bowl, Texas and Colorado, just over 35 minutes from now. In the meantime, Hasselbeck, send us one of those 17 box of Cheez-Its you have in your backdrop.
That's what you call product placement right there. That's what they teach at Boston College. That's as good as it gets.
Of course. Yep. And see, you got Matt Barry hungry. He's ready for a snap.
No doubt about it. Sanders to take off to the sideline before he tiptoes out, chased down by Steed. So the Cowboys looking to answer themselves. 6-yard scamper for the quarterback. Where did he come out firing? Brown on the carry and got right there to the marker before Jafari Harvey was there to stop him. And Harvey, one of the two guys filling in for Phillips and Roche, and trying to hold up those defensive ends. Two of the best pass rushers in the ACC. Phillips, one of the best, frankly, in the country, and one of the guys who opted out for the Hurricanes before this game. First down and 10. Short toss, broken up. And busted up by DJ Ivy, who went diving for it.
Well, we've seen the Hurricanes get beat on this little inside slant. They're playing man coverage off of this RPO. Ivy jumps it.
Sanders fired on the run, and a catch will be made by Martin. Tay Martin with a leaping grab for a first down.
Seen this a couple times too, where Spencer Sanders extends the play by getting outside the pocket, looking to pass, and good job of Tay Martin just finding a way to continue to get open and work for his quarterback.
Martin's been a big target tonight. 72 yards so far in receptions. That went for 35 yards. Handed off for Richardson straight ahead. And still on his feet, right into the pile. Dominic Richardson, the freshman. Good, under 10 and a half to play here in Orlando in the Cheez-It Bowl. It's a matchup of two ranked teams, and outside of the New Year's Six, that's the only occurrence where both teams are ranked in the top 25. Sanders to keep it, picks up a first. That's something that you mentioned at the top of the broadcast tonight, Tim. He's a better runner than he probably gets credit for.
I really believe so, and it's a good job of Oklahoma State getting to these quarterback runs, or at least the option for him to pull it and keep it, because even though Miami had defenders there, he has plenty of speed to get to the perimeter and obviously picks up the first down there.
They're going to put it in the air. Fires, caught, and another touchdown by Presley, who has had a giant night. That's the third touchdown for him in this game. He had one catch this season before tonight. A remarkable evening for the freshman.
I mean, it's remarkable is right. Almost like he was underutilized during the season. Good job of Sanders here. Looks to his left, holds the safety, and then hits Presley on the seam. And, you know, Presley has shown great quickness and ability to get off the release. And talk about a coming out party.
Sanders, a big night, 305 yards now, four touchdowns. Presley has caught three of them. That one is going to clang away, though, on the point after. But Presley continues to celebrate. He's just been outstanding.
He's been remarkable. Just does a good job working inside, ball right on his chin. Nice connection from Sanders to Presley for the score.
Well, we came on the air tonight talking a lot about number two there for Oklahoma State, Tylan Wallace, who's not played in the second half, but Brennan Presley's played the entire game, and he's becoming a star. Don't look now, but the Cowboys, who are rather noted for producing outstanding wide receivers, they've got another one on their hands.
They sure did. He touched the ball twice coming into this game throughout this season. One rush and one reception, and you know, on offense, and got more touchdowns than he had offensive touches coming into this game.
So the Hurricanes looking to answer down 37-26. Kosi Perry, the backup quarterback for Miami. And he has really played pretty darn well filling in for King tonight.
I would agree. I think he's done an excellent job. He hasn't played much this season because it's been pretty much all Derek King, and done an excellent job. Probably no better throw than this one here to Brevin Jordan on their last drive. And I would continue to put it in his hands.
11 for 20, 147 yards. And remember, there have been three dropped passes. Miami's had trouble with that tonight. It's Jordan again. Trey Sterling to trip him up. And a gain of two for the Hurricanes.
That's a big play by Trey Sterling. You're out in space against a really good ball carrier once he, you know, catches the ball. And Brevin Jordan is cutting back inside. Trey Sterling is kind of filling that hole aggressively. It's a good play against a guy who's dangerous with the ball in his hands.
Sterling Jr. from Sunnyvale, Texas. Second down eight. Low snap. Jab step again. He's going to roll and now run and gets across the marker.
Well, I think we need to give some credit to how Nikosi Perry has played to Rhett Lashley. You know, we saw Perry last year in a different offense, and he looked like a different player. And the pass protection's been better. The decision-making's been better. The overall playmaking ability has been better. And I think that, you know, it's clear that this offense has suited him.
Well, another trick play, and the tight end Jordan upended Oklahoma State. Able to cover that one particularly well. It gained only 2 yards. Under 8.5. Miami really needs points, Tim, on this drive.
Well, they do, because the clock's starting to run against you. And, you know, just think about the number of possessions that you're going to have, especially with the way that Oklahoma State has moved to football.
Perry on second and long. Pressure, and down he goes. Absolutely no place to hide. Trey Sterling once again, and he's really on the defensive side had the best night of anybody.
He sure has, and he's coming on a blitz from the bottom of your screen here, and you know, with the bad snap, I don't think Nikosi Perry was able to see, you know, what was going on down the field as he was trying to kind of field a low snap. And why all these shotgun offenses, it's so critical to get a good snap so the quarterback is able to keep his eyes up.
Sterling with 11 tackles and 2.5 for a loss. Firing again. Boy, that's a difficult catch. A fine play made by Mallory as he spins around and hangs on. Going to be very close here to a first down. 15-yard pickup. Put down and short. And off Cheney. And Cheney is stacked up. Trey Sterling again. Got in close. And they're going to say first down. On the spot. Got a good spot there.
Got a good spot. And that was a great effort. Remember, that's a true freshman running back. And he's contacted behind the line of scrimmage. He's really a speed back. He's going to get stronger. Look where Trey Sterling hits him. Just continue to able to stay on his feet, kind of twist and get the first down. Wow.
So Miami keeping the drive alive. And whistles with 6:35 to go, fourth quarter. 37-26 Oklahoma State. Trying to pick up their 8th win of the season.
Before the snap, we had a timeout for Oklahoma State. Their 3rd and final timeout. Please reset the game.
The Cowboys with a timeout. Back with more in a moment.
6 minutes, 40 seconds.
All right, a lot going on here. Oklahoma State had 12 men on the field. Mike Gundy, the head coach, called a timeout. We can't see exactly when he did that. There's also the issue of, did he want to review the spot on the last first down?
There's also the issue that the ball was snapped and Miami is running a trick play, which basically Oklahoma State then gets a look at, and so now it's a wasted opportunity to run a play that you maybe felt really good about.
So they burn that timeout. Perry on the move. He's going to lob this one up for grabs. Boy, a collision, a tough catch by Harris. Seen a bunch of those in the game, and it is a completed pass.
And this is amazing, Dave. You know, Cameron Harris is looking over his left shoulder inside, but because of the coverage, he's thrown outside.
Completion. The previous play is under further review.
So they will review this. If that holds up, it's a 25-yard strike by Perry to Cam Harris. A player is down, Christian Holmes, down for Oklahoma State.
The adjustment to the football by Cameron Harris. Now, is that ball moving? It looked to me like he caught it cleanly. But Cam Harris is looking over his left shoulder originally. Because of that coverage, the ball's thrown to the outside. His foot is on the ground when he catches that football, and it doesn't appear to move at all to me. That is an outstanding grab by Cameron Harris, and I feel like Rhett Lashley is going deep into the Springdale High School Arkansas bag of tricks.
The rule on the field is confirmed. Completed catch, first down.
25-yard gain and a first down. So a heat check for Perry now. Six consecutive completions for the backup quarterback for the Canes. Big, big one there to pick up a first down. And no quit in the Hurricanes. Perry on this drive, 3 for 3, 42 yards. He has Donald Cheney, the freshman, in the backfield with him, but he wants to throw. Throws a low one there to the tight end, Jordan, but another catch. And Miami moving the sticks. That picks up 11 yards.
And that's big because of the review. Their tempo was slowed down, and so that's why that completion to Brevin Jordan is so big.
Some of these snaps have been very tough, but here comes the rush. Rumbling toward the 5-yard line and dragged down Cheney. Bongamiga with the stop. But first and goal here for the Canes. They're driving it again. Complete to Harley. Harley looking for the zone. He's in there for the touchdown. Miami just keeps on responding. A 5-yard touchdown reception from Mike Harley. Now remember, earlier in the game, they went for two, Tim. Looked like they got it. On review, they didn't. It was overturned. 5:39 to go here in Orlando, and Oklahoma State's lead cut to 5, 37-32. Oklahoma State with another man down, Bernard Converse.
Does a really nice job of Brevin Jordan blocking on the perimeter. A lot of good things on that drive, Dave. You think about it, you think about the low snap that was fielded earlier. But here's Harley running the bubble. The inside guy in the trips to the top of your screen is Brevin Jordan. Look at him sustain his block and kind of get in the way. You know, a little bit of the pursuit as Tanner McAllister is trying to run to Harley. And how about D. Wiggins sustaining it on the perimeter? To me, that's kind of a cultural thing, an effort by everybody, and all, you know, kind of willingness to block. And think about the Coastal Perry comes into the game with a down 14.
Well, Miami once again going to line up and go for two. 37-32, Oklahoma State. Perry And once again, some trickery, and they're into the end zone. Diving in, a two-point conversion, Marshall Few. And it really opened up for the junior. And he dives in to cut it to 37-34.
You gotta love the two-point call by Rhett Lashley. Basically a reverse pass option, if you will. It's Marshall Few. Kind of gets it on the reverse. It looks like Nkosi Perry's trying to roll out. Look at the how that fools the defense. And Will Mallory had released. Well, block release. He was open in the end zone. The defense rallies to him, and then just an excellent job. And look at the excitement on the sideline. Even on crutches.
Marshall Few, for the first time this season, gets into the end zone, a two-point conversion. And a three-point game with 5:39 to go. Anybody's game here in Orlando in the Cheez-It Bowl. Presley has been such a bright star. And back for the kickoff by the Hurricanes. And down the stretch we come. .39 on the clock here in the fourth quarter. Back to the studio and Matt Barry.
Guys, if this is the beginning of our bowl game Tuesday, sign us up for the nightcap. Texas and Colorado coming up just under 15 minutes. Valero Alamo Bowl. Will this be it for Sam Ellinger at UT? That game kicking off shortly when you guys go final.
Hi, Matt. Thank you very much. Now, Sanders has had a terrific ball game. He's 37 attempts, 27 completions, 304 yards, 4 touchdowns, but they need him again. He's also rushed for 46 yards. He's going to hand off here for Brown as they stay on the ground on the first carry. LD Brown. And he will gain just 2 yards to bring up second down and 8.
And I think Miami has decided to commit to stopping the run, playing man coverage. I think if Oklahoma State is going to get it done, they're going to be forced to put it in the air.
Sanders, honorable mention, all Big 12. To this point, best day of his career came against Texas in the overtime loss. 400 yards, 4 touchdowns. On second down. Short pass, and it's knocked in the air, nearly picked off. Bubba Bolden was there. He'd like that play back.
Is it Miami's decided to get way more aggressive? See the motion across the formation to get soft coverage, but then they just drive on the route. It's Bubba Bolden basically seen that outcut too many times and jumped it. That forced Sanders to hold on to the football and coverage again across the board.
3rd and 9. For the Cowboys. Sanders, incomplete. To bring up 4th down and 9 for Oklahoma State. Gervin Hall on the coverage.
I'm a little bit surprised that Oklahoma State didn't try a double move, something more down the field, because I think that this Hurricane secondary has seen too many of these. And a little option route, quick outs. We saw Bolden jump it, and there goes Gervin Hall jumping that one.
So Tom Hutton to punt. Harley back to receive. That was a 3 and out under a minute, by the way, so that was awfully fast. Going to let that one take a hop, and it keeps on rolling for the Cowboys inside the 20 to about the 19-yard line. Fans, check out the ESPN app for the Capital One post game immediately following tonight's game. Now the punt with the bounce went 55 yards. So now the real test for Nkosi Perry, the junior quarterback, forced into action tonight when De'Ara King went down with a leg injury in the closing minutes of the first half. Remember, Miami trailed at 1 point in this game, 21-0. They have never led. Jordan in motion. Perry took a look at him. Now he's going to throw it deep and hang it up, but it's going to be incomplete. Mallory never really saw that. Brings up second down for the Canes.
And that was really similar to the play they had run earlier to Brevin Jordan, where you know, they faked that bubble, which they've run a couple times now. Oklahoma State wasn't buying it. It's the first incompletion for Perry in a while as well. Had eight straight prior to that.
It's been a very hot hand. Second down, 10. Pope on the move. He's going to swing the pass incomplete up and over the head of his intended receiver, Donald Cheney. So third down and 10 as the Cowboys look for a big-time stop.
And that was going to go big time there. They had him on the screen. They had a pressure, you know, a screen into the blitz, going to be a big play. Now a really difficult situation to me. It's Harley or Brevin Jordan if I'm Nikosi Perry.
Gains 3 out of 11 tonight on third down conversions. And here they come with pressure. He gets nailed. He got the pass off, but it's broken up by Thomas Harper. They wanted Jordan again, who has been such a huge target, but busted up by the Cowboys.
That was all out pressure, zero coverage, and Perry's going the right place with the football. Gets it out on time to Brevin Jordan, and that's right to his hands. It's a great job of Nikosi Perry hanging in there. As Harbell peels, running free right up the middle to get a shot on him. That was a really well thrown ball to Brevin Jordan. To me, you know, the story for Nikosi Perry, it's been these drops.
And Lee will launch the punt. Stoner will take it inside the 30-yard line to begin to drive for the Cowboys, on top by just 3 points here. With a little over 4 minutes to go, a 53-yard punt by Lou Headley. Spencer Sanders with a star turn tonight here in Orlando, Florida. No question about that. 304 yards passing, 4 touchdowns, no interceptions.
You know, Dave, that 10 for 46 rushing, I think, could come into play here. And the quarterback run game may be a way to salt this one away.
Sanders to keep it. And as you predicted, he's going to take off. As Frierson took him down for Miami, a 2-yard pickup for Oklahoma State.
Here's the thing, you have to account for the quarterback as a runner. Miami continues to play with a safety deep, and so the quarterback run game is very much in play until Miami decides to bring everybody to the party. Then in that case, you have to try to find a way to win a one-on-one outside.
Second and long now for the Cowboys. 3:33 to play. Sanders tucking it. Keeping the football again. Spencer Sanders with the carry. And a timeout. 3:21 to go.
Miami. The second of the half. 30-second timeout. Please reset the game clock to 3 minutes, 24 seconds.
So Miami with one timeout remaining. Time to get it back to the studio. Here's Matt Barry.
We love a former all Big 12 bowl game. Colorado obviously in the Pac-12 now, but they get set to take on Texas. If your game runs long, we will kick this game off on ESPN News. So if anybody is unhappy about that, hit up Tim Hasselbeck on Twitter. He'll answer all of your questions when that game kicks on ESPN News.
He always does, and very bravely.
Yes, I mean, it's a positive place to communicate with people. So enjoyable. Good interaction, Dave. I know you love it as well.
Healthy interaction, yeah. Third down and 6. And a 3-point game here. The Cowboys trying to hang on. and pick up another bowl win. 15 consecutive bowl appearances for Oklahoma State. Miami has dropped 9 of their last 10 bowl games. And that's going to be incomplete. Pass to the sideline, broken up by Gilbert Frierson, intended for Stoner.
And again, it's this little, you know, 5-yard out, this quick out from the slot, and Gilbert Frierson jumps it. So we've seen Bubba Bolden jump it, we've seen Gervin Hall jump it, now Gilbert Frierson, and
on 4th and 6. Miami bench, the first of the game.
So back-to-back 3 and outs by the Miami defense to force the punt. 8:20 to go. And we did see both of the Australian punters, Tom Hutton for Oklahoma State and Lou Headley from Miami, getting together for a handshake before the game as they were both warming up. Hutton's 30 years old, Headley's 26. Gets that one away, and a fair catch here by Harley. 36-yard punt. So here's our game summary here in the Cheez-It Bowl in Orlando, Florida, 37-34, Oklahoma State, but they got out in front by a bunch, 21-0. Sanders really hot early. He's turned it in an outstanding night. Derek King had to leave the game. The Miami quarterback, the knee injury in the second quarter, unable to return. Brennan Presley, the freshman wide receiver, who only caught one pass all season long, has 3 touchdowns tonight for Oklahoma State.
It's been a lot of fun, headed towards a great ending.
Perry is going to keep it and dive ahead. Cozy Perry, not necessarily his game. Tyler Lacy with the tackle. And certainly King throughout the season, and deep throughout his career, one of the top dual threat quarterbacks in college football. 2nd and 8. A pass incomplete. He wanted D. Wiggins, but busted up by Christian Holmes, who is out for a while and now has returned in that secondary.
I said it last time. Last 3rd and long, Oklahoma State came after Nikosi Perry with 0 blitz. And you know, I'm not sure that Jim Knowles, who likes to switch things up, you're going to end up doing the same thing. So with that being the case, it's a pretty good shot. You could end up seeing some type of zone coverage here. Our pair had work inside.
3rd and 8 over the middle. Catch by Jordan to pick up the first. Still on his feet. And getting out close to the 50-yard line. You talk about a determined effort after the catch by Brevin Jordan.
Yeah, this is big. It was zone coverage. They played it soft. Switch up from the last 3rd and long. And a good job. He caught it short of the first down, but excellent run after the catch by Brevin Jordan.
16 yards. Perry lining up. Deep throw. And broken up. Boy, almost had Mark Pope for a gigantic gain. But the Cowboys break it up.
A true freshman, Corey Black, running with Pope. That's another drop, Dave. Mark Pope has got that in his hands. And so, by my count, that's at least 5 big ones.
Yes. 5 drops for Miami should they lose this game. To be dumped to Chaney, and Chaney dragged down by Trey Sterling. We have called his name a bunch tonight, so that gets just 1 yard.
Now we get to 3rd down, and here's what we've seen. We've seen all out pressure. Then we saw a soft zone. If I were Jim Knowles, I would probably go back to what I had success with, which was coming after the quarterback.
3rd down and 9 for Miami. Under 2 minutes to play. Perry out of the shotgun. Over center, broken up again. Once again, Jordan was the man they wanted, but Harper was there. Thomas Harper to break it up.
Listen, it was pressure. It was pressure again on that 3rd down. And so Look, this is the game of chess. You're wondering what you're getting. Are you getting that all-out pressure that you've seen on two of your last three third downs? Are you getting some type of zone coverage? Truthfully, I think Jim Knowles is coming after you because that's what he's had success with. So that being the case, I'm working a one-on-one. It hasn't worked with Jordan. I'm looking outside to one of my wide receivers.
On the pressure, he got it off and a completed pass. Michael Redding. Stopped by Malcolm Rodriguez, but defensively they come through again and unable to pick up the first down.
I think Rhett Lashley was expecting the pressure, which is why they go with the wide receiver screen. It is zero coverage. They just get too much pursuit. That's just great effort from Malcolm Rodriguez, because if he doesn't turn and retrace and go make a play on the wide receiver, that's not only a first down, but potentially game-changing score.
So the Cowboys with the stop of the night with a minute 36 remaining here in the Cheez-It Bowl. And what has been a very, very entertaining night. Spencer Sanders, the quarterback for the Cowboys. Boy, did he come out slinging it, Tim, and he was impressive.
Well, he almost earned Miami player of the game in the first quarter, Dave. He was that good with how we started and just continued to battle. I mean, over 300 yards passing, see the four touchdowns. Was also smart with the football. You know, and then obviously the rush yards as well. And to do it without your best wide receiver in the game in the second half, and he was outstanding.
Well, Tylan Wallace did not play in the second half. That was a player decision, not an injury situation, but Sanders was able to find a bunch of other guys, Brennan Presley in particular, who just had a big, big night on a big stage for Oklahoma State. So Cowboys have found yet another talented wide receiver. Sanders takes that knee. Presley with three touchdown grabs. I don't know, that first one really set the tone for the whole night. That leaping catch to beat his defender and then jump into the end zone with a great second effort. That was a heck of a play.
Great point, Dave, and that was a fourth down. You know, talk about setting the tone. A fourth down play where Miami probably felt like they had a pretty good call, and Spencer Sanders, you know, escapes to the left, makes that throw, and Presley, for his second catch of the season, makes an outstanding play. And he was terrific tonight. You mentioned the talented wide receivers in this program's history. A solid play at the quarterback position can help that as well.
5-yard penalty.
Delayed game flag here. So, Tim, how do you manage the last couple of plays?
Well, you've seen this with how they've decided to kneel the ball down. They try to, you know, take a little time off the clock before, you know, you go down. And you know, 4 seconds is a lot to try to do that with. And so
Miami has declined the 10-second runoff. The game clock will start on the snap.
The Cowboys so beginning. Yeah, there's celebration. They're down at 25, and he will duck down. So the final half minute of play here in Orlando. Oklahoma State with the Cheez-It bat coming up. Sterling and Presley certainly deserving that honor of carrying the great big bucket of Cheez-Its. And Miami about to drop to 8-3 for the season. There's your final score here at the Cheez-It Bowl, Oklahoma State 37 and Miami 34. Tim, your final thought.
Well, listen, I wanted a fun game to watch. You know, people opting out. It was great competitiveness between both teams, a show by both offenses. Let's hope this is a start to a great Tuesday night of football.
Well, next on ESPN, we send you to San Antonio, where Texas takes on Colorado in the Valero Alamo Bowl. For Tim Hasselbeck and Katie George, I'm Dave O'Brien. Thanks for watching.